Memes. Memes! Welcome. Welcome, gamers. How are you all doing? Hope you're doing great today. I'm feeling wonderful. And I basically had more time in the morning than I originally thought. So I figured, why don't we go through the Trash Taste subreddit, which has been having a bit of a interesting period, where they've just been making their own stuff, I guess. Normally subreddits would cover, I guess, stuff that happens. Instead, they were like, no. That's too boring. How about we just make up our own lore? Honestly, I respect it. It seems like the subreddit's going through a kind of a boom in content. I'm all here for it. The amount of content that's gone up recently on the sub. Me, I'm fucking doing it all. It was me all along. I put it all up. No, I don't know. It's I think the last meme review, it was like there's only a few good memes, but it looks like now it looks like there's so much shit. Like it's gone absolutely ballistic with content. So. Massive W for the subreddit, and we're gonna go through it all today, so it should be fun. Dr. Ligma, yeah, Dr. Ligma makes an appearance, of course. There's so much stuff. I got my MCM ticket. That's what I'm talking about. Let's go. I'm so hyped for MCM. Is anyone going to MCM here? Wait, it's like DGen hours for UK viewers right now, bro. It's like 3 or 2 a.m. I think it's 2 a.m. right now. You got my ticket? Oh fuck yeah, dude. Yeah, we are. I don't know when we're doing a panel, but we are doing a Trash Taste panel. And I believe I have signings like every day. So I will be just at a point every day where you can come and say hi to me. So that's totally fine. I got a... Oh, God. Yeah, so that'll be fun. It's weird. I don't know how crazy it's going to be. I guess before we jump right into it, we can just chat for a little bit. Yeah, I don't know. I haven't been to a con in, fuck, how long's it been? August 2019? So, 3 years? You know what's weird is, like, normally, you know, as I was getting, because I'd go to cons, like, every, like, I want to say 2 months at least, right? And then and during the summer, I'd normally go, like, every month. Like, I could see, as my YouTube channel was growing, more people would come and, like, talk to me. Or whatever, or say hi to me, or recognize me, or shit like that, right? Obviously, that makes sense. But now that it's been 3 years, and we've, like, exploded, this has been, like, my biggest growth period ever. I'm like, scared. What the fuck's it gonna be like? I'm like, bro. I don't know, we'll see. I don't know. Yeah. It's kinda be weird. I don't know. We had meetups at MCM every time before, but I don't know if that's good now. Because last time I was blocking the walking path. I don't think I can do it now. I might get in trouble. I just want to piss people off. That's what... Probably pretty wild. I don't know. Yeah, you guys say get security. Is that like a thing? I've never heard of that. When we were talking to some cons, they were like, yeah, we'll get you security. I'm like, what? What? What do you mean, bro? What the fuck? Are you back from the UK? I haven't left yet. I'm leaving on 2 days after the mouse IRL stream, so tomorrow. So yeah, we have like I'm leaving literally right before the con. You need security? I don't think you need security. I don't know. Not for UK. It's like my hometown, isn't it? What? I can't turn up to the UK. What? I'll be fine. I'll be alright. Helps with mobs? I don't know. I'll be alright. Knife? No. Oh my god. Birmingham? I'm not going to Birmingham, so it's fine. I'm also not going to Manchester. I don't think so. Maybe I will. I don't know. It's not too far from where I grew up. Manchester was like the closest route. No, it wasn't. Like Liverpool was like the biggest city near me. Oh my god, we have Hype Train? Oh my lord. What if the security are Trash Taste fans? Oh, yeah. You're not gonna meet Danny G, sad. Okay, if Danny G promised to meet up with me, I'd go to Birmingham. Just to get him to record the line. If he promised that he would do the thing, I would go all the way to Birmingham. VOD is not being recorded. The VOD is being recorded, it is. Yeah, I got DMCA'd. I think because I played the music too loud yesterday. Yeah. But, I mean, I won't play music today. So, yeah. I'm not gonna do that. You gotta go to Penis Stone, just for the name. Is that a real place? It is. In England. What? Where is this? Of course it's like above Sheffield. Oh god. Why is it called Penis Stone? Oh, it sounds like Penis Stone. A penny stone. Not Penis Stone. It looks like Penis Stone though. JoJo fans going crazy. Can you sing again? No, I'm retired. I need to get you. VOD is not being recorded by Twitch? I think it is. Why wouldn't it? Is it not actually? Does Twitch just not record my VODs now because I've been a naughty boy and I got two DMCAs? No VOD there? Oh. Huh. I wonder why that is. Maybe it's something in my settings. Always publish VODs. Oh yeah, they've turned it off for me. Huh. Okay. That's strange. I guess I will publish the VOD afterwards. Oh shit, Super, I don't know how to pronounce his name. Sonic 05. Something Super Sonic 05. Thank you. Thank you to all the subs as always, guys. Appreciate it. Alright. The time I heard you sing, they couldn't handle how good it was. I mean, the VOD's going to be uploaded to YouTube, and I recorded it locally, so it'll be, yeah. I'll turn the setting back on. I mean, I'm not gonna do it again, so I don't care. Always publish VODs. There we go. It's on now, chat. Okay. Damn you, Twitch. It's in the subreddit too. Of course it is. Everything's in the subreddit. My entire life. I'm pretty sure my social security number, if I had one, would be in the subreddit. Don't know how that would be possible, but it would. Okay. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Would you guys prefer me to pretend like I didn't burp and just do like a subtle one, or would you just want to hear it? Alright. Let's have a look. Let's begin. Let's do it. Alright. Alright. I guess let's just jump into the dark timeline of Trash Taste, which I know very little about. I mean, we'll just see. It's kind of confusing. And by kind of, I mean extremely confusing. Alright, let's, So this is, part of the dark timeline. Like, look at this shit. Like, what am I... what is this? Okay. Actually, you know what? Let me, fit to screen. Just do this. Let me just do this. Okay. I want to get rid of the fucking things that look ugly. Duff streamer. Let's go. Okay. So, this is already really confusing. Look how big this is, first of all. There's more on this side of the screen as well. You can't see it. There's more to the end. Also, I should get my cursor captured. It already is. Okay, it just wasn't doing it for some reason. Very pog. And it just, just got rid of it. okay. Alright. I guess we'll just show my Twitch for a second. There you go. There's you guys. And then... Where is it? This one? Okay. Okay. My cursor still isn't captured. What a great thing. Why does it capture my cursor? Oh shit. Wait, how do I zoom in? Wait, okay, this is the zoomed in. Alright. There's a newer one? I know there's a newer one. Look, so this is like, this is the dark timeline. Oh no, wait, this is the dark timeline. Look at the difference between this. There's like a whole layer added on and they've mixed stuff around, right? Let's go to the newer one then, I guess. This is insanity, by the way. Okay, so this all means nothing to me. Noriaga, thank you for the 5, and McSnuggins, thank you for the 10. Alright. I mean... What? Look at that! I don't even where the fuck do I begin? All right, let's go. Let's follow the white one first. All right, let's just do. Let's just follow the start, and let's have a look. The initial world timeline. Gant never quits the BBC. Okay, so this is already not. This is already not the timeline. Okay. Gant never quits the BBC. Maylene never sees potential in any tube. Trash taste is never conceived. Gant and Sydney live happily in the UK. Though the lack of something always lingered in the back of his mind. Connor and Joey die suddenly. Cause unknown. Fucking hell. Should I be worried, bro? I like how there's a date as well. Okay, that's passed, luckily. Promotion Varys connection lands Gant a job at CERN. Okay. He felt emptiness in his life. He couldn't explain. Reference in the meme. Great. Gant has talked about things he regretted in his 20s related to his original life path. So obviously in the original timeline, he didn't take the big fulfilling risk to leave the BBC to fill the emptiness and correct the mistake of pursuing the life of mediocrity. With the BBC, he used his engineering background to build a time machine and go back in time and leave the BBC. Okay. Professor Gant Menetabo, PhD. Becomes the head director of DNL Mail Project. CERN develops a time machine capable of sending radio waves to the past. Okay, this is Steins Gate. All right. Sent to a random truck driver. Oh my god. It's going to be a fucking isekai, isn't it? During the first trial, Professor Menetabo felt a strong urge to redo his life. Knowing the risk involved, Gant sends the second email regardless. One that can have major repercussions in the space-time continuum. JCM is born. Who the fuck is JCM? Okay. And then Steve Handjobs. Okay, so then Gant passes. Okay, so Gant passes sometime 2060. All right. Okay, so... Joseph Connor Menetabo? What? Why? Okay, so that's one timeline. So this is the timeline where Gant never quits the BBC, makes a Steins Gate-esque time travel machine with CERN, becomes a doctor, and then sends messages back. So I guess let's follow the first timeline that starts in 2030, which is this purple arrow. Oh my god. In a completely random world line, Gant gets hit by a truck. Gant's afterlife arc. What? Oh my god. Okay, hold on. This is too... Okay, let's not go to this one. This one's really confusing. Okay. All right. So is this Dark World timeline? Where's the Normal World timeline? Trash Taste World timeline. Okay, this is the normal one. And it starts four timelines... All right, okay. So let's start with what we know. Okay. What the actual fuck? Yo, I don't know how stars line on this one, but I just posted the meme video I was working on 2.5 weeks ago in the sub earlier, man. I hope you see it. It's titled, We Must Reach Trash Taste. I can check it out. Let me turn text-to-speech on, actually, because it's just me today. It's just me! Alright. So, Sydney convinces Gant to quit the BBC. Alright. Let me zoom in more for you guys at home. Maylene sees potential in AnyTube. All right, so this is the current timeline. 8 Gant email reaches Studio Wit. All right, we don't know who this is from. Trash Taste Episode 1. Sydney convinces Aki that she should always hide under the bed during an earthquake. All right. Vague messages from Casualty Conductor Slip, though Trash Taste World Sydney. Casualty Conductors are pipelines that transfer memories. What the actual fuck? What is this? Sydney introduces Connor to her favorite club. Everyone survives Fukushima earthquake. Okay. r/ Trash Taste memes about Connor and Joey dying. Gant and Sydney wedding. Future is uncertain. Trash Taste ending. Okay, so this is the timeline we're on now, I guess. Okay, then I need to figure out. Okay, so I guess the dark timeline is where shit kicks off. Let's go to that one. Oh my god. Okay. So. This is the dark world. Christ. Okay. Gant receives phone message. Quits BBC. So this is from the previous Gant on the BBC timeline. Where the second mail reaches Gant. So dumb. So Gaunt then quits the BBC, mainly seems potential
testing,
in...
Testing does nuts.
Thank you, thank you. And this is from... What, okay, wait, what's this from? What? Okay, this is from the end of the... Oh my god, okay. Let's come back to this. That's really confusing. Maylene sees potential in AnyTube. Project Melody finds Hime Hajime. Trashes episode 1. Hime starts VTubing in the hopes of meeting her grandfather. Only her fellow genmates know her true origin. Okay, so then... This is where the meme started, kind of. Connor and Joey died in the Fukushima earthquake. And is this from another timeline? Okay, this is from another timeline. Alright. Second annual Trash Taste Awardee proceeds. Gaunt begins to produce entire episode by himself. Didis and Emily recruited to replace the boys. Gaunt suffers from severe emotional damage, rejecting the change. I wish Gaunt would just let it go. When Geeks said Trash Taste must go on and recruited Emily and Didus to take the boys' place, Gaunt just kept saying, "What are you doing?" Connor and Joey are still sitting there while talking to himself and laughing alone. Okay, so Gaunt goes like crazy. Gaunt never moves on. Trash Taste disbands at episode 252. One last charity stream is hosted by Chris, who finally becomes a member, even just for a little while. Hi guys, welcome to Trash Taste. I'm here with the boys. Gaunt, you have to let it go. It's been 3 years since the earthquake. It's okay, it wasn't your fault, but you need to move on. Trash Taste 252. They are gone again. Okay. Are you an official Trash Taste member? Yes. What did it cost? Everything. Okay. Gaunt then returns to the UK. Something happens. Gaunt stumbles upon blank blank blank. The strange man advises him to visit the clock tower in Westminster. Someone down the line could be watching this. If you want to save Joey and Connor and everyone else, you must complete your mission. All right. Okay. Being the MC that he is, Gaunt learns that he is descendant of a lineage, okay, literally just Attack on Titan, bearing a powerful stream magic crest, having the potential to harness true magic. The only thing preventing him is his stubbornness, a byproduct of trauma and depression. Jesus, constant, extensive, and arduous training has led Gaunt to snap. He will keep moving forward until his friends are brought back. Gaunt has mastered the process of attaining true magic. Only a catalyst is needed to reach the root of the world. Why is fucking fate granddaughter here? What does this mean? Convergence point 2. First DNA mail sent. Okay, so the sent mail is sent now and it fucks the timeline up. Alright. Following the events occurred in the metaphysical realm, the root of all worlds, events, and phenomenon existing whenever, everywhere, and nowhere else simultaneously. The first DNA mail is sent, breaching the fabric of space-time enough of a window and for Supreme Sorcerer Gaunt to perform second plus third magic. What is second plus third magic? What the fuck is this? Oh, what did I just zoom in off? This is so complicated. I guess this is like trying to understand 1% of fate lore. Okay. Jesus Christ. What is this? Okay, let's zoom out now because now it's getting big. Okay, this is so long. Alright. Okay. Let's... Alright. Okay. Gaunt enters the root of Akasha? Is this fate? Is this fucking fate? Did they put fate in Trash Taste lore? Where he fights the Warden of Time, ends up triumphant. Yeah, I saw this fan art. We'll go over this later, because I'm pretty sure this is, like, upvoted. Yes, fuck's sake. Why do they have to put fate? Dark Gaunt Supreme is unleashed. Dark Gaunt Supreme. Dark Gaunt creating the Dark Timeline so he can be released from eternal imprisonment. Alright. I've been plotting his release from the... Dark Gaunt uses D4C... Why is JoJo in this? Boosted by a... what the fuck? This is some mad fucking... fan fiction. Gaunt Battle Royale. And then it goes to... Dr. Ligma jumps into battle. What's Ligma? Ligma balls. Dr. Ligma jumps into battle. Dr. Ligma stops Killer Chris. Who is Killer Chris? The battle never ends. Okay, wait. What? Who is Killer Chris? Releasing the dark timeline. Okay, so that it goes up to here. A casualty conductor unravels the mind of Chris Broad, creating an alter ego named Killer Chris. The true crime documentaries be like, he was Mr. Affable until he wasn't. Okay, and then Dr. Ligma stops Killer Chris. Okay. Dr. Ligma doesn't stop Killer Chris. Okay, it's an alternative timeline. Okay, where I don't stop it. Okay, so this is the one underneath, right? Okay, this is... Okay, it's a fucking loop. Okay, that does not help me at all in trying to figure out what the fuck has happened. So there's a divergent point here. Gaunt never meets... ? Gaunt Golden Requiem World... Okay, of course. We're just making shit up now. The green one... Where does this go? Okay, yeah, so I'm going yellow now, right? Yeah. I feel like there was some cohesiveness. And then we have Golden Requiem. Failed transmutation causes a crack in space timeline, temporarily showing afterimages of the boys. A random Aaron Mika fan. Oh my god, is this Aaron Mikasa fan from the fucking fan mail thing? Frustrated by the Attack on Titan ANR ending sends Wit Studio. I don't know what that means. I'm not going to read into it. I'm guessing that's a spoiler. Gaunt, no matter what you two are, whether it's halfway across the world or an isekai away, you'll always be with me.
Third magic essentially makes the soul immortal, and second magic allows the existence and travel between parallel worlds. Oddly fitting.
Fucking fate. Joseph Connor Manepto is born into this world. Okay. Joseph Connor Manepto.
Now, making things up now? What have you boys not told
us? It was all real. It was all real until now. One of them was Monkey, and he had some of the shittest takes I'd ever known. Fascinated of his dad's innumerable stories drives JCM to seek out a way to bring back the boys. Okay, shit, the thing keeps moving. Okay, the clock tower goes public and has collaborated with the scientific community regarding various projects. JCM creates the perfect big titty dragon waifu using magecraft and robotics. What does this mean to the story? Why is this here? Why is this just shown in here? Oh, it's Hime. Okay, I was like, why would they just mention that? JCM wins a bunch of awards, lands a job at CERN. Dr. Ligma doesn't stop Killer Chris. Killer Chris steals JCM's research notes and sends his past self a DNA mail. JCM is selected for time travel trials. Both the DNA mail and second magic will be used. God never really gets a proper send-off to YouTube and Trash Taste way back when it disbanded 35 years ago. One last time, Gaunt turns on the camera. Hello, and welcome to another episode of Trash Taste. I'm your host for today, Gaunt. And Gaunt Manepto dies? Jesus Christ. And so that goes back to the green one, which has an alternative timeline. Okay, I guess I'll follow... The green one comes back, right? To the start with the ? Okay, so I'll follow the green one. Due to methods JCM uses time travel, it becomes... Oh, for fuck's sake. Akasha. For a moment, Galter uses time. This, who the fuck is Galter? Is it Gaunt in some way with a fate character? Galter escapes Akasha thanks to JCM's time traveling. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, this one's way more complicated. Let's go Gaunt Alter for fate fans. Let's go with this one. So Dr. Lima doesn't stop Killer Chris. That's terrifying. Goes down here. And then, okay, Killer Chris murders Sydney before she meets Gaunt. Jesus. Gaunt stays at the BBC. Killer Chris films a documentary on Kadokawa. He finds Maylene, convinces her to let him host the podcast. Killer Chris has convinced Joey and Connor to join him. Podcast originally called the Broad Podcast because its acronym was BBC. The name changed to Broad Taste last minute. Broad Taste 1. After a series of direction disagreements, Killer Chris murders Maylene and takes full control over the podcast. Decides to build his studio a year early so he can hide the bodies in the back room. ASO Natsuki becomes the unofficial fourth member of the Broad Taste. All right. Killer Chris gets Jerry Natsuki to go to Mount ASO like normal, but the volcano erupts. This timeline kills both of them. This pushes Killer Chris to a new level of insanity. The first anniversary of the podcast, Killer Chris has managed to maintain the podcast with random guests and Connor's help. Connor is starting to become concerned about Chris's mental state, however. The day after the first anniversary, Killer Chris uploads the Journey Across Japan series Uploads the Journey Across Japan series as if Joey and Natsuki hadn't died. This causes a huge controversy and divides TT fans. Oh, it's not TT now. I thought it was BT. Despite the controversy, a shortened version of Too Much Volcano is number two on the iTunes indie charts. Connor demands that Casey stop profiting off of Joey's death. Killer Chris begrudgingly agrees. Okay. The podcast is less profitable after the controversy. Killer Chris takes over the Anime Man channel to try and make up for the losses. Connor tells Killer Chris he's quitting the podcast and becomes a VTuber. All right. Killer Chris is angry and tells Connor to meet him at the ramen set the next day after rigging it to collapse in an earthquake. The earthquake doesn't happen. Wow. I banked on an earthquake to kill someone? Finds Maylene's body along with several others. Having discovered the truth, he quickly leaves Japan to escape Killer Chris and go and hide him. Killer Chris releases the podcast with new hosts. It begins to gain popularity. Connor begins to study Magecraft and Hamon. Of course I do. In case he needs to defend himself. Killer Chris, still searching for him, gets into Japanese politics. What? Killer Chris becomes Prime Minister of Japan and starts a global manhunt for Connor. Connor summons a bunch of alt versions of himself to stay hidden. Okay. Killer Chris abolishes the Japanese constitution and reestablishes Imperial Japan countries are invaded to find Connor. What? Connor masters true magic on Hamon. He dubs himself Dr. Ligma. He learns of the Alpha World line and sets off to escape Killer Chris. Dr. Ligma, he learns of the Alpha World lines and sets off to escape Killer Chris and become powerful enough to end this bullshit. Okay. Killer Chris has destabilized global peace, the world on the brink of nuclear war. Okay. World War III ending. Okay. So, wow. So Dr. Ligma is born. And then I go into... Okay, so I go into this one. All right, so now I need to follow the green line, which is this one? No, this wasn't the green one. The green one was... fucking hell. No, this wasn't the green one either. Jesus Christ. Was it the pink one? It was the pink one as well, right? I think it's the pink one. We've done all these ones, right? Yeah, we were on the pink one, though. Okay, so this is Gaunt Altar. But this is a part of the Trash Taste one. Go to the afterlife. Okay, so maybe, let's go to the afterlife. All right. Wait, what's this from? Oh, it's when we died. So when we died, we went to the afterlife. The boys enter the afterlife. A heaven, perhaps? Wait, no, they landed in Quindisim. What is that? Death Parade Special. Oh, it's from fucking Death Parade. Jesus Christ. Chadcast spinoff starring Death's Apprentice and the boys. All right. Gaunt's world line is under the... continual protection of the Interdimensional Council of Gigok. Once the sought-after perfect world line disputed over countless wars, a small faction of Gaunt who wanted to preserve the beauty of the world line created an organization that no one dares to provoke. This is just Rick and Morty now, I guess. The boys get isekai'd. Okay. Gaunt's blessing on the wonderful world. Okay, so we're in the Trash Taste... isekai. Alternative isekai world. I died in an earthquake and I got reincarnated in another world as an archdemon I admire. Okay. Just throwing that in there, I guess. Gone is isekai, having more none of his meds. He slowly loses self and identity. The locals start calling him Ringo. What? Getting hit by a truck did hurt for sure, but I finally got isekai'd. Jesus Christ. And this comes from the Gone's afterlife, where he gets hit by a truck, I'm guessing. Oh, this is when he sends the first DN... Gone in a completely random time. It's okay. Wow. Okay. Gone gets isekai'd. Getting hit by a sword did hurt for sure, but I finally got isekai'd. Hey mate, you're finally here. And then we just played the... We just have an isekai time, and then yeah. There's a bunch of random timelines. Only Gant survives Mount Fuji eruption. Ends up in Avengers Endgame. Only Gant survives Hokkaido snowstorm. In the middle of the two, Gant becomes a professional cyclist after biking special. Oh wait, is it the same meme? Oh, it's the same meme. Oh, he's shitting and okay. Only Joey survives the earthquake. Joey is now looking at himself. Okay, okay. Okay, so after the trash taste ending, we tried alchemy and almost died. Good trash taste special. And then let's say Dark Gaunt is about to kill Gaunt, I guess. Connor and Joey bring back Gaunt through human transmutation. All right, Full Metal Alchemist. through human transmutation. It fails. Homunculus Gaunt never develops a consciousness. All right. Sigma Gaunt enters the empty homunculus shell. Sigma Gaunt and Galta have a standoff. Galta perishes instantaneously from Sigma Gaunt, mere radiating presence. Good taste. Lasagna ending. Okay. Gaunt invades a peaceful attractor field. Oh, so this is when Gaunt comes in from the other timeline. So Gaunt comes in from this timeline when he escapes Akasha thanks to JCM's, thanks to the sun time traveling thing. All right. Gaunt's afterlife. So if Gaunt dies here, he goes and isekais. Okay. But then there's Sigma Gaunt. Sigma Gaunt enters from in the middle of this timeline after me and Jerry die. Sigma Male Gaunt World Timeline. The Alpha Sigma Male constantly on the grind. Unfortunately, Crust has been banned from the world. Sigma Gaunt has reached peak Sigma grind set that he seeks out another world line out of spite, creating the DN Male to send his consciousness into another attractor field, and then goes to this one, and then beats Galta. Okay, that makes sense. What is this stuff? Okay, I think I've covered it all then, actually. That is very complicated. That makes some sense. So, there's also this stuff. I don't know what this is. This is terrifying. This is from the live stream. I can't show you it. No, Gaunt suddenly turning sad moments are just memories from his counterparts. Okay. I guess that's the timeline. That's very complicated. Very messy, I want to say. And by very messy, I mean extremely fucking messy. I don't know if it makes sense. I want to say no. Don't worry about it. I guess just don't worry about it. I guess that's the takeaway. Just don't worry about it. Just have a good time with it, dude. It doesn't need to make sense. I guess you're right, chat. I guess it doesn't need... it's not about making sense. It's about the journey. It's about the memes we created along the way. I think my brain hurts. But I think that's good. All right. I guess it's a normal meme review from here. But I think a lot of the memes are going to be from the thing. So, I mean, yeah. Let's make this bigger so that we can do it. Do the thing. We can have a look. All right. No, it's too big. All right. Sure. That looks like a... Wait, no. Let me move it up here. All right. This is the most uprated meme of this month. Which is Connor and Joey go to heaven and start a podcast. What's up with heaven? Like, why is it so bright? What's up with that? British man comes to heaven, complains about its brightness. Oh my god. You know what's fucking weird is that I can 100% see myself doing this if I went to heaven. I don't know. This is so fucking on point for how I, for me as a person. I would 100% get to heaven and be like, why is it so fucking bright all the time, dude? Like... They've somehow perfectly captured my energy. I don't know how they managed to do
it. Joey and Connor in heaven. Okay, I was with this timeline stuff until now.
So I assume this is from the timeline when me and Joey die from the earthquake. Like, what's up with heaven? Like, why is it so bright? What's up with that? It's definitely something I would do. That's so I hate how fucking accurate that is. It's so me. I would definitely fucking do that. Oh, for fuck's sake. It's I would so do that. Fucking hell, dude. God damn it. Joey would do that too. Joey would immediately say, British man comes to heaven and come. He would do that. He would immediately do that. All right, what's this? Okay, we have a trash taste meme trailer. Let's turn the music off for a second. Trash taste dark timeline trailer.
Tokyo seems to have taken the full force of the earthquake. At this point, unconfirmed reports indicate that large areas of land are underwater.
What?
I have never seen my street almost in complete darkness.
Wow, it does sound like Gone. What the fuck? It is Gone? What the fuck? This is just the emoji, just, okay.
Fucking God!
Boontron as well, okay. Booby's there, why not?
Fuck!
What is that?
It's your boy, Chris.
Wow. That's pretty good. Wow, that Marvel logo is so fucking good. Holy shit. Wow. All right, shit. I gotta upvote all these. I forgot. Oh my God. That's pretty good. All right, that's pretty fucking good. Fucking mouse at the end. That's pretty amazing. Good job. Oh my Lord. That's pretty good. If I can skip this song, it's not lo-fi enough. Never thought trash taste lore would be harder to follow than fate lore. True. It is harder to follow than fate, I think. I don't know. That didn't make any fucking sense. Two types of gremlin. I hate Cedar Vale, lol. Okay, see you tomorrow. I think Cedar, oh God, it's that fucking awful tweet. What in the actual, I won't read it out. It's too blasphemous to read out. Turned out better than I expected. Let me get this. Finally, Felix coming to Japan. The boys going to UK for Gant's wedding. Yeah, it's unfortunate. Very unfortunate. Oh God, it's so sad. We literally got here as, we left. It was really fucking annoying seeing everyone be like, "Oh, Felix, episode 100. Felix, please bring him on, bro." No, we couldn't, bro. It's just. Timing was bad. We literally packed up all our filming gear, dude. It's we can't film anything, unfortunately. So we couldn't. We got to meet though. Yeah, we met though. He mentioned it in his video. I saw that. I hung out with him though. We got to talk, but we'll have him on when we come back. I mean, it's not like he's only gonna come on once. I imagine he'll come on a bunch. So yeah, you know, it's not a big deal, you know. I wish people would just chill out, you know? He's gonna come on, it's gonna be chill. Also, it'd be nice to have more time to just talk with him personally, so we all get more comfortable. Like, he hasn't even met Gant yet, so... I think it'll be a better podcast if we've all hung out a bunch more. So, I'm in no rush, personally. Yeah. Oh. Alright, tweet of Gant and Sydney. I guess I'll just skip that one. I'll skip this tweet as well. Because it's just... Alright. Fucking Rainer just being cringe, Jesus. That's not a bad edit of Gone. Trash taste in the multiverse of madness. It would probably still be better than the actual multiverse of madness. Shit was boring. boring, all right? I'm going to say it. I'll get cancelled again. I'll get cancelled again for it. I don't even mind. That's really good. Oh, shit. All right. Zooming out just a little. All right. What if Trash Taste is a boy band? What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? Why do we look like that? What the fuck? What the fuck? Why? Why? I look hideous. What? What? It weirdly works for... Gaunt? Does it? Gaunt doesn't look that weird. I look weird, though. I think so. I don't know. Gaunt kind of looks okay. I don't know. I don't know if I'm just... I'm losing my mind. After exploring Europe, fucking English! After exploring European countries for a few days, I gotta say, OK Bread is actually all right. I read that weirdly. OK, there should be a comma. Bread is actually all right. I mean, everyone knew this. Everyone knew this already. Like, what do you mean, Gaunt? He's just. I remember Gaunt had this realization and he came to us, and at least I think to me, because my parents, as a kid, I always wanted to go like America or Asia, but obviously like that's like way too far. So my parents always took us to like Europe, and obviously that's already like privileged as fuck that my parents would take us around Europe. My parents are like big brain though. They would do it on like such a good budget. And like my parents, we like never ate out when we were in foreign countries. They would like rather like kill me than eat out. We always had to cook, which I didn't mind. But my parents were like pro at doing it on a budget. I don't know how they did it. I'm too fucking lazy to try and like think it all through. But I'm very lucky though that my parents took me to all these countries. I look back, I hated it as a kid sometimes because it'd be like we're going to fucking France for like the 15th time, and I'm like, I'm so, why? So I could eat a baguette for the 15th time? I remember I just hated French kids. French kids were the worst, dude. French kids were so fucking rude. Spoiled kid problems, I know. Because I just wanted to play video games, right? This is the thing. My parents would drag me away from my Xbox, and all I wanted to do was just play Xbox, and my parents would be like, all right, okay, so I wanted to play Xbox for like 10 hours a day during my summer holidays, right? So my parents, I would be like, thank fuck, dude, I can finally play Xbox for like 3 weeks straight. And then my parents would be like, all right, we're going away for 3 weeks. And I'm like, what? During the summer holidays when I can actually play Xbox for like 12 hours, you drag me away. So my parents, we'd go to France, and yeah, it was fun. I liked it, and it was chill. But like, we went to France every single year for 3 weeks. And like in hindsight, I'm very grateful. As an adult, I'm very grateful to my parents that they did that, because now I feel like I learned a lot about other countries. But I was a kid that did not appreciate it. That's fucking sure. Oh my god. Not privilege problems. These are gamer problems. It's true, man. It's true. I wanted to. This is when I just got like, I just discovered online gaming, and to me that was like everything I wanted to do. I had like a DS, and I liked that, but I just wanted to play gaming, dude. I hate going abroad. Now I like it. Now I'm very grateful. But Gaunt never went to Europe. This is the whole point of this, by the way. I never went to Europe, Gaunt never went to Europe, and I was very lucky that I managed to like go around like everywhere. And now I tell my parents this all the time, like, I'm very thankful. Thank you. I'm very lucky. You guys are the best. I appreciate it. When I was like a little kid, you can't appreciate that shit. There's nothing wrong with admitting that you were a little piece of shit, chat. It's called growth. It's called growing. Don't act like you were the beacon of smartness and the beakness of virtue. There's nothing wrong with that. Why are you guys acting like 12-year-old me had any notion of being privileged? I didn't give a fuck. I wanted to play Modern Warfare 2 every day. Are you kidding me? Yeah, so obviously adult me realized I was a little shit, and I should have appreciated it more, which I do now. You know, my parents would like, it's crazy, because like you could, I mean, obviously pre-pandemic, you could travel Europe on like a giga budget, dude. Like traveling from the UK to European countries could be done so fucking cheap, and it's just a lot of work. We just took a tent. We had like a giant tent. I don't know how much it cost, but like we drove down to Dover, I think, or something, and got the Eurostar. What's the train where you would load your car into this metal like coffin thing, and it was a train that went really fast. Bend over. Eurotunnel? Yeah, Eurotunnel, that's it. We'd go on this thing called a Eurotunnel. Let me show you guys. Sorry, I'm going on such a tangent, I know. Not Eurostar, Eurotunnel. It's like this, you drive your car into like this. Let me show you. You would go into something like, it looked like this. Like this. You'd park your car in this, and it was very, very cheap, I believe. And you would just be in this for an hour, and it would just be shaking. And then you would just get there, and then you would drive again. I remember, it was horrible. Because it was, I have three brothers. And during this time, it was only like, it was my older brother wouldn't come traveling us. So three of us would be in the back, right? And it was so cramped, because my parents would buy alcohol to take with them, because it was cheaper to bring the alcohol than to buy it in France, because they would get like a deal on it. So they would bring like crates of alcohol for them to drink, and like we would be in the middle seat, right? Because obviously it's not going in the back, because that's where all the tent and shit go. We're like in the back seats like this, like in a fucking 12-hour drive, like parents, can we have leg room? And bro, if you were in the middle, if you were in the middle seat, GG, dude, GG. You just hate your life. That's the most British thing ever. Yeah, my parents, they didn't give a fuck. If you were in the middle seat, it was just game over. You would just have no legs by the time you arrived. You would just, I'm not wearing socks, that'd be weird. You just have to sit like this. We, of course, we like bullied our little brother into doing it most of the time. Feet, there you go. That's one for the wiki feet, boy. Yeah. It was, my poor little brother got bullied into it so many times. That's why my little brother hated us. We would just bully him into it. I would never go in the middle. Because I, even though my older brother was older than me, I was like bigger than my older brother. So, yeah. But it was fun. I like travel. Sorry, I went on a massive tangent. Sorry. That was an absolute giga tangent. Point being, I got to travel Europe a bunch, and the one thing that I did realize was that bread is bomb. Bread is fucking amazing. So yeah, that's what I learned. French likes to, they like to be like, oh, we have baguettes and croissant, and yeah, it's great, it's cheap, well done. But like, Germany's just steps ahead, you know what I mean? Germany has already thought past that. Where are your pretzels, France? You don't have them. Sorry, Maylene is streaming. No hard feelings, my dude. Go ahead. Damn, your older brother's older. Speech 1000. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna say. Wow. My dick grew 3 inches after completing Metal Gear Rising. 4 inches is great. Bro. Wow. So you've heard of the darkest timeline, but what about the idle timeline? What is this? I guess they just do the same thing. Same thing as what Joey and Gant do. That's the thing that they do. No one has ever done that before, Gant and Joey. I'm on the train and someone is listening to Trash Taste loudly on their phone, and now I can't escape no matter what. Yeah, that's fair enough. I already upvoted this. This art is so good. Bro, this art is sick. What good art, dude. I love the style of this art. This art is so fucking good. Bruh. When you realize all the boys now have a manga adaptation. Fucking hell, that scared the shit out of me. Let me turn that down. Alright. Way too dank. Holy moly. Wait, what's this one? Oh, is this artwork? I guess I'll see that later, I suppose. All right, this is an alternative timeline. What if it wasn't Gaunt this entire time? Let me turn it down to like this. Let's go! Oh my god! Oh my god! I'm stupid! I'm stupid! No! Yo, that's good. Wow, that works so well! Let's go! Oh my god! Oh my god! I'm stupid! I'm stupid! No! That works worryingly well. What the fuck, dude? Why does that work so good? Alright, that's good. That's fucking good. Holy shit. This is the timeline where I review anime. Yeah, I guess so. It's never gonna happen. Holy shit, dude. Getting caught by Sydney while trying to fix the dark timeline with the help of other versions of himself. What? Oh, I guess because it's the Spider-Man universe movie. Spider-Man has a lot of movies about universes. Gone getting caught by Sydney. What? Timeline shenanigans. Yeah, I guess a lot for it, sure. Gone finds out who has been killing Connor and Joey.
Interested, there is completed up-to-date version of the timeline that was posted a few days ago.
I think that was what I was going through.
It earlier. Enjoyed the stream.
Gaunt finds out who has been killing Connor and Joey in alternate realities. Okay, sorry, let me read this. Wait, what is this? Oh, it's like a monitor of himself. Okay. It took me a second to get. Why did it take me so long? It's himself. All right. I get it. Okay. It's Galter. I wish they photoshopped Gaunt onto the person. Oh my god, I keep burping today. I'm so sorry, chat. What's this? Oh, yeah, Ashley's leaving. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I saw a lot of people speculating about that. I mean, I won't talk about it much because it's not like, you know, it's at the end of the day, it's a private thing. But, you know, when you have interns, you only really keep them on for a certain amount of time. And, yeah, I mean, if you have an intern for X amount of time, then you can't really find anything to justify a full-time position. You know, unfortunately it happens. No, there's no bad blood or anything. I saw people like weirdly speculating like, oh my god, the conspiracy theory of what could be. No, it's not that complicated. Why does Joey look like a dad appreciating a neighbor's lawn? What? Oh god. All right, let's have a look at this.
This, I feel, look really, really nice.
What is this? Let me blast the volume.
I really need to organize my manga bookshelf like this. I feel, look really, really nice.
Dude, Jerry does radiate such dad energy, dude. Look at the way. I don't know, dude. Oh, Jesus, dude. Like, he's just... oh, shit, I gotta tell you. Like, look at... Like, he does this. Is it like a hobo? That's what he does, dude. Need reenactment. He's got such dad energy, man. I don't know how he does it. He really does kind of like radiate that energy. I don't know how. I feel like he's just so chill and Australian. He's just so laid back, so he just kind of chills out, and it's just so funny. He really does. It's the very light arm movements to gesture as well. It's like not even he's not like over there, it's like, you know. It's the point with the coffee that seals it. True. It's like such a minimal. Look at that. It's like a dad would never do such bold movements. It's just a light thing of like, look over there. What the fuck is this? Welcome to Trash Taste Podcast. I'm here with the boys. What the fuck is this? Who is this? This looks like if... like a poor man's Zac Efron. Who's this? Maylene, Sydney, and Aki. What? This is so cursed. This is so cursed. Doesn't it look like if... oh yeah, it doesn't look like if Sydney was... was Zac Efron. That's what it looks like. It doesn't look real. Hey, yo, if you look like the middle guy, DM me. What, like a frat boy? Dude, oh God. All right, Didas the Sensei Hunter. Superior Trash Taste is finally here. MILF, you can't defeat me. We know, but he can. Teacher. I like the teacher tag though. The teacher tag is hot. It's good. It's good, dude. Like, come on. Who doesn't like the teacher tag? Come on, man. It's the same thing. Kinda. Alright. Oh God, this meme. I wish Gaunt would just let it go. When Geeks Plus said Trash Taste must go on and recruited Emily and Didas to take the boys' place, Gaunt just kept saying, "What are you doing? Connor and Joey are still here," while talking to himself and laughing alone. It's oddly, like, depressing, though. Like, reading it. Just, like... because it's about, like, me and Joey dying. So, it's weird. It's kind of, like... it's really funny at the same time, but then it's, like... bruh, what if... like... oh, God, dude. The start of Trash Taste Law. The end of Trash Taste Law. True. True. Oh, God. Leaked image from the Trash Taste wedding special. What even is this headset I'm wearing? How many cameras is that? That's like... I can't show you guys. It's fucking... hold on. Is that even me? That looks like Chris. That doesn't even look like me. That doesn't... like, look at that. That doesn't look like me at all. One camera, two. What would be the purpose of this many cameras? That doesn't look like me. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh, what? 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 Why making me go back? No. Okay. POV, you're an ugly bastard, I guess so. Connor, when streaming with Iron Mouse. Connor when streaming with Aethel, Nyan, and Mouse. True. It's because they turn into such weird energy together, you know? It's true. You know, I mean, it's fair enough. I'd say it's fair enough. 360 wedding. I'd say this is pretty accurate. This is a pretty accurate meme. Oh, God. Can't use this Dragon Balls? What is this? State your wish. Bring back the boys. Trash Taste, bring back the Trash Taste boys to life. Your wish has been granted. I gotta zoom in. Thanks, Gaunt. People really hated my food tastes up there. Gaunt, do you know suck on? Suck on. Suck on these nuts. And that's the origin of Sad Gaunt, I guess. What are the comments saying? Okay. It's just the sad Gaunt emote. Oh God. Look. There's so many fucking... does it continue? How much does it continue? Oh, that's it. Okay. I thought it would be an endless continuation of sad faces. Oh my God. Look. There's so many comments. This is insane. Felix moves to Japan. Yeah, that's true. That, oh my god, it's calmed down a lot, but holy shit, that first week was so annoying. Oh my god. Yeah, it was like every single 10 seconds, it was like, guys, PewDiePie's in Japan. Guys. So I'm glad it's calmed down a lot, though. I asked Felix, I was like, has anyone been, like, spamming you to talk about it? And he was like, no. And I was like, all right, good for you. He was like, he mentioned that, like, yeah, that he mentioned the same thing in his video, that people are being, like, weird about moving to Japan. I don't know, people get weird when you move to Japan. People are like, oh, I bet he's gonna leave. Oh, he doesn't even speak the language. People are so weirdly defensive about people moving to Japan. Like, if you moved to Cambodia, nobody would fucking bat an eye. People would be like, what the fuck? Alright, enjoy Cambodia. Do you speak the native language? Nah, of course you don't. They don't give a fuck. But when you move to Japan, oh, suddenly! Oh, do you know all the cultural norms? Oh, do you know this? Japan now?
Trash taste episode when?
Fuck you. When we're back. Yeah, I don't know. People just get weirdly defensive about it. I don't understand why. Like, when you move here, you get a lot of people who live here and who don't live here. Majority of them don't live here. And it's just, like, jealousy of, like, oh, you're gonna quit. Oh, you're not gonna like it. You know, and I can understand it in some senses, because a lot of people are gonna be like, oh, well, you know, they would never have the opportunity to move to Japan and live there, like, recreationally, you know, because getting a visa is hard. But also, you know, I don't know Felix's visa, but, you know, most countries, if you're of a lot of wealth and you're like, hey, I will pay taxes in your country, a lot of the time, the country is just like, come on in. Yeah, and is it pay to win? Yeah, but I mean, who gives a shit? I mean, like, at the end of the day, it's kind of just how it works, right? Government wants money. It happens in every country. People only suddenly give a shit when it's Japan because they can't get in, right? You know. And then there's a lot of people who live here who also gatekeep Japan. That's a thing as well. A lot of people live here. They like to complain about it. They like to say how shit it is. But the moment someone wants to come here, they're like, whoa, what the fuck, dude? Bro, another gaijin entering? Bro, you're not going to be like me, who's like super respectful and speaks the language properly and stuff. And it's like, bro, it's so cringe. It's so cringe. I don't know. It's, you know, I get it a lot too. A lot of people, you know, a lot of people who want to give me criticism for whatever reason. You know, there's a lot of things that you can criticize me for. But the one thing that I can just tell, people are just, you know, grasping at straws, is that, you know, people love to try and make out that the fact that I don't speak fluent Japanese is somehow disrespectful. Or somehow is just a horrible thing of me to do, you know. And my Japanese is by no means perfect, but my Japanese is at a level where I can hold.
I've met a lot of fellow foreigners who do get really toxic.
Yeah, they do. They do.
Often, it's the ones who are stuck in a bad.
That's true. It's very true.
Project.
Yeah, it definitely is. I think, you know, my Japanese level is at a point where I can hold a basic conversation with people. I can talk to people, I can ask them questions, I can do all that. Obviously, you don't see a lot of that on camera, because there's no need for me to do it. And a lot of the time, when we're in a video setting,
to Puerto Rico, everyone would question it and ask why if you don't know anything about the culture.
True.
Hashtag facts.
You know, in the videos, I don't often speak Japanese, because if we're doing a video, I want there to be no miscommunication. The video is going to be shit if I'm half understanding what the guy's saying. In me personally, when I'm talking to someone, I don't always understand what they're saying. I listen out for keywords, and then I normally understand what's kind of happening. I understand enough for the conversation to happen. But yeah, people are so weird about it. People get really defensive about it, and they just want to use it as a way to invalidate me for some reason. I don't have many detractors or people who dislike me. But it is just a frustration to see people who do that. And yeah, it's weird. It's just strange. It's very bizarre. But yeah, no, my Japanese is at a point where I can do everything on my own. I can rent cars alone. I can go and do everything alone. I can go out to eat. I can go to the ward office and do all the documentation. I can go to the bank alone. I can do everything alone in my life here. There are certain things that I bring someone along because I don't want there to be any miscommunication. Like, you know, if I was going to file my taxes or something, I want someone who is native to help me. Even if I was fluent, I probably wouldn't trust myself to do it. You know what I mean? Because I just, that's something super serious that even if I felt like I was fluent, I wouldn't feel confident. You know, and you know, people are like, oh, well, stuff is so hard. People have to understand that there's also English options for everything here. Do you want a dentist who speaks English? You can go to one. There's also, like, you know, a lot of dentistry in Japan is quite behind. The practices are quite old. So, you know, you can go to an American dentist here. They speak English. You can get an accountant here who speaks fluent English and Japanese. You can get a doctor who speaks English. Like, anything of importance, you can get someone who speaks English, right? Everything else you don't need, right? Like, I don't need my fucking waiter to speak English. So it's like, all right. But with my health, okay, maybe I'm going to need the guy to speak English. It's just like, people are so weird about it, you know? And, it, you know, it comes from a place of jealousy and stuff. But it's just this really toxic thing about, for some reason, Japan, where people who live here, people who don't live here, are just really strange about it. Yeah, and I'm glad I wasn't alone, but I feel bad that Felix had to endure it, because Felix hadn't really talked about it much or brought it up, but he was like, when he moved here in his video, when we met him, he was like, yeah, it's really weird. People just started being really fucking weird about it. It's strange. You know, there are a lot of people who live here in Japan who, you know, Japan is one of those countries where, if you work here as an English teacher, it's hard. It is not a fun country. It is brutal. You don't get paid much. You're broke all the time. And your working hours are really tough. And, you know, it is not the life you think it's going to be. And more often than not, a lot of those people don't like it. Not generalizing, but a lot of people who are, like, very toxic here about it are normally just unhappy with their own position, and they don't like it when someone's moving here who isn't going to be doing that. Like, I'm very, very lucky that I can live here and kind of just do what I want. Like, I'm not in a schedule. I can just do my work. So it makes Japan way more fun and a lot easier to live in. I pretty much get the best parts of Japan without all the bullshit, and I'm so, so lucky for that. And I know that. You know, and I think anyone who watches my content and sees that and can see any of my stuff in Japan can see that I'm very respectful of the culture. You know, people never try to come at me for that. So it's very frustrating that people then try and they're like, okay, well, if he's not disrespectful, let's go for the angle that he's shit at Japanese. Sorry for the rant. It's just one of those things that comes up often enough where it's just annoying. Very, very frustrating. Rant over. Yeah, I don't know. It sucks. I don't have many haters. I don't get this often. Like, I rarely ever get any, like, bad shit thrown my way. I'm very fortunate that it doesn't happen, you know? There's just a bunch of people every now and then that go for this narrative of he can't speak Japanese, thus, you know, he's disrespectful or stuff like that. Most of the country doesn't even learn the language, etc., etc. And it's like, well, no, I learned enough to get by. Like, I've never had a complaint by a Japanese person that, oh my god, you don't speak enough to live here. You know, I speak enough to have conversations with people. I explain to them that my Japanese is not great and that I might not understand. But, you know, it's about asking them to just rephrase the question or rephrase what they asked in a way that I can understand. And, you know, people are really patient about that, and I really appreciate that. And my Japanese is improving. My listening is so much better than it used to be. I don't talk about this, but, like, I watched... Like, I mentioned I watched, like, the Odd Taxi movie, and I watched the Jujutsu Kaisen Zero movie in cinemas. There's no subtitles. I watched it. I understand, like, 90 to 80% of what happened in Jujutsu Kaisen Zero. And then afterwards, when I left, I just... asked Kaho, I was like, is this what happened? Can I just confirm this? Like, I'm so proud of myself that I can go to the cinema and watch a movie in Japanese and, like, follow what's happening. Like, I actually know what's happening. That's insane to me, considering I came here and I didn't really know anything. I came here, I didn't know anything. I was learning what green meant on the flight over here on Duolingo. And, I barely have lessons. You've a lot to be proud of, and the minority being butthurt are people who aren't worth it. You're doing incredible. Been watching you for a long time, for years, to be honest. You're proud. Thanks, man. Yeah, it's, you know, I've learned most of my Japanese from just talking to people and just putting myself out there and putting myself in those uncomfortable positions. And it's honestly been the best way for me to learn. I go to lessons once a week, but I haven't gone in like a month because I've been so busy. And I had the subathon, a bunch of other stuff happened. And yeah, you know, like I literally did that with just 2 hours a week of studying and just talking a lot. Honestly, talking to Japanese people helped more than anything by like a mile. It like wasn't even close. How did you end up in Japan anyway? I just got invited over and I just thought, fuck it. Yeah, Japan's a fun country. All right. Still has young neurons. Must be nice. Youth is superpower. Maybe. But like, it's weird because like, I'll know what people are saying to me and sometimes I'll even know how to reply, but I won't know how I knew that. Like, I'll know what to say, but I'll be like, fuck, wait, what does that mean? And I'll have said something back just instinctively, which was correct, but I didn't know it was the right thing to do. Which I guess is like, means that you're storing it, right? I don't know. It's crazy. You do the same in French? Yeah, like, I just respond. I say something, and I'm like, fuck, I don't know what that meant. I have to, like, think about it. I have to, like, get to it. Split personality? Yeah, maybe. Dark timeline. Japanese is stored in the balls? True. Yeah, I don't know. I'm excited, because, like, you know, when Emily and Didus came, Emily is learning so fast, dude. Emily is amazing. Emily is putting herself out there super fast. It took me so long to get the confidence to do it. Emily is just like out there already, learning, trying everything. Yeah, it's she's cracked. She's gonna be so good, dude. She's gonna be so much better than me. Emily and Didus were like so impressed on the like first day when I was doing everything for them and talking for them, and like Emily went to the store and I had to like talk for her and do everything, and she was like, holy shit, how did you get so good? And I'm just like laughing and like in broken Japanese, like, dude, you don't even know. I barely know what the fuck is going on. But now Emily's learning more, and now she's like, now she, like, the veil of, like, when you don't speak a language, even somebody holding some form of conversation seems so impressive until you start learning more, and then you realize they don't actually know that much. Like, Emily would be like, what did he just say? And I'd be like, I don't fucking know. I just said yes. I'll be like, I don't fucking know. But, like, sometimes... Here's the thing, right? You'll go to a restaurant. Sorry, I'm going on such a long tangent. I promise I'm nearly done. You'll go to a restaurant in Japan, right? You'll sit down, and there's like, there's always the questions they ask you, right? This is just what you pick up from being here for so long. So you just wait. You sit down in the restaurant, and then she starts talking like super fast, the waiter, or he starts talking super fast in your ear, right? I'm taken off guard, so I'm not listening. So now I'm like losing, right? So now I'm trying to listen and pick up some words, and then she'll just be like, D-d-d-d-d-d-d-d-d-d. And then she'll just say a word like arugi, and then cup, right? So it's like I don't even know what you said. You could have been talking for 30 seconds, and all I heard is the word allergy, and then you ended it in a question. So then you can just be like, okay, well, she's just asking me if I have an allergy, all right? I'm squeezing all this down into that, and then I'm just like, no, I don't have an allergy. And then boom, there you go. That's like that question, that is done. They fluff the talk so much in restaurants. They say so much stuff here, and then they actually ask you what they're asking. So just listen out for like keywords in restaurants and stuff, and yeah, you'll be fine. Yeah, Keigo is 99. Yeah, it's like so much fluff that you don't need to pay attention to. You just need to get what they're actually asking you. Because, you know, if you're in a service thing, they're always going to be asking you questions. Sometimes you won't understand what they're asking you. Like, it took me a while to realize, like, I didn't understand why the taxi driver was asking me a certain question. It turned out, after 3 or 4 times of being in a taxi, he was just asking me what if the temperature was okay. And I just never had this happen in taxis, so I never, like, expected it to happen. But then now I understand that, okay, if I go in a taxi, I tell him where to go. He's going to ask me if the highway is okay, if using the navigation is okay. Because sometimes People don't want the drivers to use the navigation thing. I don't know why. So they ask you if it's okay if they use the GPS. And I'm like, what? Yeah, dude, I don't give a fuck. Please use the GPS, actually. I don't want you to not use it. I don't... You're like 90. I don't trust you to go the right way. Please use the GPS. And then maybe they'll ask you if the temperature is okay in the car. Especially in like summer or winter when, you know, they can't quite kind of get the temperature right. Passengers worried they'll get in an accident? Maybe. Maybe. I don't know. Fuck, I'm sweating so much. Why is it so hot today, chat? Japan summer. Oh my god, I can't wait to leave, dude. I can't wait to go to the UK and not be sweaty. Oh, yes, blast me. Okay. You can use your Japanese pronunciation to read and talk in Spanish. Romanji sounds exactly the same as Spanish. It's the same as Welsh as well, actually. So, very fortunate that I'm native in the pronunciation of one of them. But the worst part about speaking somewhat Japanese, I'll say. Somewhat. Like, I can... The first parts of the conversation, I sound like I know my shit. I sound like I know everything. And then, so they get more confident in talking to me. And then they start asking progressively, like, more natural and native conversations. And then I'm like, oh god, do I now pretend that I know what they're saying? Or do I just say I don't get it? On the taxi, you know when I did the IRL stream at Maylene's house? On the way over there, the taxi driver spoke to me the entire time. And the first 10 minutes of the conversation were pretty chill. I understood like everything he was asking me. He was just asking me about what I do for work, what kind of foods I like, you know, why am I in Japan? You know, he's telling me about his life and stuff. And then he started asking me stuff about my hobbies. And I started trying to explain some things to him that was really hard for me to explain because my talking isn't as good as my listening. And then he started telling me about his life. And I just started like finding it so hard to keep track of what he was saying because he was talking for so long. But he was like, he told me he used to be a cop and then he worked in a garage. And then now he likes to drive in his free time. And so I was trying to change the conversation to get to easier stuff so that I didn't have a harder time following. So I was like, oh, you like cars? Oh, what cars do you like? And then he would tell me what cars he liked. Then he would start going back to something. And he was a taxi driver and he was telling me how about he got caught speeding as well. And I was like, what? What? Am I understanding this correctly? It was intense. And then near like the last 10 minutes, I was like, please talk in a little easier Japanese. I'm having a hard time following. And then he was nice about it. It's pretty chill. They make a lot of effort. I think if you get through the first parts of the conversation in Japanese to Japanese people, 90% of them are super chill and they're just really fucking glad that you don't that you speak Japanese. They'll open up and warm up to you super fast. If you know just a little bit of Japanese, Japanese people are so willing to talk to you and kind of just be patient with you. If you don't speak a tiny bit of Japanese, they'll kind of be like, oh, God. Because they love to see that you make the effort. I'd say even if you're coming to Japan just to visit, just learn very little phrases. And I promise you, it'll go a long way. They really, really appreciate that. I'm telling you, they will be so much nicer to you if you speak the tiniest bit of Japanese, because they feel like, okay, this guy's going to make the effort. This guy's going out of his way to try and understand us. If you turn up and you just start speaking English at them, they'll be like, okay, this guy's just, he just wants us to accommodate to him and then he doesn't understand anything. And now it's going to be hard for us to understand everything. So it's kind of, I don't know if it's the same in other countries. Maybe in France, they're normally chill. I remember when I would try and talk to them in French and they would just be like, fuck off. They would just be like, fuck you. What do you mean you don't know what I'm saying? I'd be like, un baguette. And then they would like, and I'd be like, I don't know. And then they'd look at me like, I don't know why. French people are always really like intense about it. I don't know why. This is why I have trauma with France. This is why I hate France. I always make jokes about France. That's the British side of me. Dude, I just remember they were so mean when I was a kid. Dude, they're very protective of their language. I just remember they were so mean. They're always so mean. But then some people were really chill. You would meet some really, really nice people. But every now and then you would just meet people who were just fucking like, why are you 12 and don't speak French? What the fuck? What the fuck is wrong with you? Oh, God. Jesus Christ. All right. Let me go be right back and then we'll continue with the memes. I'm just going to go and get a little yogurt. I'm really hungry. So I'll just go and get it real quick. I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. We'll continue with the memes. Do not leave or go anywhere. We have so many more memes to go through. Be right back, chat. I'm back. Sorry about that. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, shit. That was from, I guess that's the mouse link that she gave me. What the fuck? What the fuck? That's crazy. That was the link. The one where, you know, we have mouse on screen? That's crazy. That's not my window. Wow. Oh my god. So I ate really quickly while I was waiting for my coffee to make. Okay. Back to the memes. Sorry for ranting about living in Japan. People just suck sometimes. but like, yeah, I mean, overall, TLDR, my Japanese has gotten a lot better. And yeah, I'm enjoying living in Japan a lot more because of it. It definitely helps a lot. All right, where were we? Girls with time machine. Am I your daughter? Am I your daughter? I am your daughter. Really? Boys with the time machine. Connor, Joey, come have dinner at my place tonight. I was gonna hang out with Takeshita and Chris, but yeah, sure. All right, I'll bring Aki along too. Why are you crying? Holy shit, dude. Dude, have you guys seen Takeshita? You see him on AWE? He's like killing it, dude. Let me have a look. AEW? Fuck, same shit. Same shit. Let me have a look. You see this? Look at this man. Look at him. Holy shit. Look at him go, boys.
Years of age, Konosuke Takeshita, with almost 10 years of in-ring experience. And just a few weeks ago on Rampage, very nearly upset Jay Lethal in his AEW Rampage debut, were it not for the intervention.
That's wild. Last time I hung out with him, went to like a karaoke bar, and he just took over the bar and just started singing. It was so funny. Dude, it feels like everyone loves him though. I saw like, he's so talented, just nothing short of amazing. I just saw so much like positive support for the dude. I'm really glad he's doing well. He told me about it before he went, actually. He was like, yeah, I'm gonna be in America for a while. And I was like, yo, that's fucking hype, dude. His English is pretty good as well. And even when he didn't understand anything, he would just smile. He's like, it's so fucking funny. Giga Chad, he is literally the Chad. All right, what is this? And the meme of the year goes to, guys, what the fuck is the dark timeline? This wasn't the one of the nominees. Guys, oh no! Sag, dude. Sag. God, it's oddly depressing, kind of seeing these memes. Chris and PewDiePie after the boys left for Japan. Oh my god. I loved you since the day we met, but first, a word from our sponsor. Dude, could you imagine? You know, fucking Pewd should have done that, dude. He should have done that. He should have had that on his wedding. It was a video. He actually made a video out of it. He should have done it. He should have done it. Upvote. Why not, dude? You could say to the sponsor, listen, this is going to be like at least 2 million view video. Video. What am I saying? That's like double the rates. Come on, dude. What, like 100 grand? Come on, give me 100 grand. I'll put you on my wedding. Easy. Easy, dude. Recoup the costs, dude. Imagine you get to the wedding and it just says hashtag ad outside. All right. What is this?
I've got to fucking do this. It's taking all my energy. Oh shit. Guys.
Okay.
No. I gotta turn back. Time.
fucking ReZero thing in the background?
I'm sorry.
Wow. Wow. Who knew Gaunt was so powerful? These two together are so cute. I swear they are. I'm excited. Excited for the wedding. I can't wait, man. I'm so hyped. I've never had like a close friend get married before. It's crazy, dude. I'm like, let's go, dude. Did you meet Pewds? I did, yeah. He talked about it in the last video. Why would you ask me that? What, you think he's lying? Yeah. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. Trash tastes law before the earthquake. Return to monkey. Trash tastes law after the earthquake. Dude, it's so true, dude. It's fucking mess now. What is all this shit? What happened? This is fucking dumb. It's so dumb. What happened? There's also... Dude, there's so much good fan art. Like, look at this shit, right? Gaunt's bizarre adventure continues. Someone made this fan art. I've seen it already. It's insane. Okay. It's like a story. Gaunt's like... Well, if it isn't my good friend. And then it's Mori. Gaunt, look at that! That looks so sick, dude! Gaunt. Callie. Sorry to interrupt, but... I can't just let my friends kill each other now. Bro, look at this shit! This is insane! Bro! Callie-senpai! Bro, why is this art so insane? What the fuck, dude? It's just nuts. Like, look at the quality of this. This is just insane. I'm holding it. I think Gaunt didn't give out the reward. No. The award, so I'm gonna hold that. This contender. It's just such good art. Let's give out love and support for Gaunt. He's trying to fix the timeline. Dude, I want to get one of these so bad, but I have no room. Literally, the only thing stopping me from getting more merch is I don't know where to put it. I can't get any more things from my office without completely fucking it. Unless I got another one of those things over there. But, I don't know. More amazing art. Okay, this is why Joey isn't watching Arcane canonically in the Trash Taste timeline. Okay. I should probably start watching Arcane. Gotta open my PC. What the? Fuck! Joey, stop what you're doing! It's Dr. Ligma. Okay, Pog. Who the hell are you? Wait, why is Joey American? Oh, who the hell are you, mate? That's, I can't do Australian. Huh? I am the one and only Dr. Wait, Connor? Wait, what? No. Wait, no, I mean, yes. Anyway. You better never watch Arcane, or else you'll break the whole space-time continuum. By watching it, you will gain knowledge that will cause a breaking point in the timeline. If you do this, you will die. Huh? Okay. Well, it was nice meeting you again, Jerry. The anime guy? Tell me what happens to Ligma. Who's Ligma? Dr. Ligma Balls! Shit, he just broke my screen. Oh my god. Such cool fan art, dude. Just insane. Like, the level of fan art that's come out of this is just awesome. Like, holy, like, look at this. This is insane. This is so good. Massive props to whoever made this, man. The fuck? Intel driver support. Thank you. Well, why is my VOD recording broken? Because Twitch turned it off because I got DMCA'd. I've turned it back on, though. Oh my god, dude. Sydney moment. What a great time, even if I had a little too much soju. This is pretty normal. This is pretty normal. Pretty normal behavior. Sydney bringing all her pocket pussies to England. The fucking poor TSA people who had to check her bags, dude. Oh my god. Could you imagine? You open it up and they're like, Sydney's just like, oh yeah, That's for my work. They're like... Holy shit. It's so true. Because she must have brought them back for her latest video, right? Sydney is a total degenerate. If God didn't lock her down, it's missing context. Even the round table? The round table weighs like 10 kilograms. Ain't no way that's getting in the baggage, dude. Ain't no way. Alright, what's this? Oh my god. So bright for a moment. Why is it so high res? Jesus. Okay, hold on. Okay. The brightest timeline. Connor and Jerry survived the earthquake. Chris's studio is safe. Pizza crust banned worldwide. That's not good. That's not good at all. Scientists prove that chicken is better with the bone. Joey starts watching anime again. Iron Mouse comes to Japan for Trash Taste official guest. British people exist. Waifus are real, this one says. And then finally, you can't see it. Oh, shit. Gartner's happy. Oh, good ending, eh? Good ending. Except why is Pizza Crust banned? Pizza Crust shouldn't be banned. Come on now. That's wrong. Okay, what's this?
We just had an earthquake. Stop reviewing Dark Timeline. You'll cause the big one.
We had an earthquake? Earthquake Japan. Let's have a look. Today? Apparently there was a two earthquake. I mean, I didn't even feel anything. Trash Taste Law. How do I stop it? It can't be stopped. It's self-sustaining now. Jesus Christ. This is my boyfriend, Aethel, and this is Aethel's boyfriend, C.W.E. True, dude. True. Vain gang, dude. Vain gang. Man, Aethel's been real quiet, man, since Monopoly. What's going on with that, huh? What's going on with that? I wonder where he went, huh? Why is he being so quiet? Huh? Look at that. Where's Aethel, man? Where's he been, bro? Just left the Vain gang, dude. Fuck, dude. Gon got a glimpse of the boys in timeline 0.4645678, but he's not strong enough to bring them back yet, which he must start watching Full Metal Alchemist. Just you wait. I'll come back for you. Wait for me. Did you see that Gant said that his favorite anime was Full Metal Alchemist? I'm here too, don't worry. Aethel, do what you're doing here. How are you in my chat all the time, Aethel? How are you always here when I need you, bro? What the fuck? How you been, man? What you been up to? Don't be a stranger, you know? Don't be a stranger, dude. Vain gang forever? Hell yeah, dude. He's such a troll. You just chilling here, Aethel? You just chilling? You just vibing? Is that it, huh? Oh my god, dude. Oh my god. Vain gang. Alright. The epilogue to the dark timeline. I just went to the gym, bro. Dude, I was gonna ask you this. I meant to ask you now. When I'm in LA, can we do a workout session together? I've been going like every day recently. I'm on a grind. I need to make sure I'm consistent. Let's work out. Let's do it. I don't know if I can come to your gym for like a day. I can just pay for a month membership or something. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Stream? No, bro. It's Vain gang shit. It's just Vain. It's Vain gang stuff, you know? I need to work out in the US. But you need to like bullshit me. You got to get me into the gym somehow. I'm pretty sure I need to pay for membership. Maybe I can just sign up for a 1 month membership. I don't know. Dude, of course, I'll take you in my gym, man, to let you in. Fuck yeah, dude. All right, very big pog. Let's do it. Joseph, Connor, Manetipo, you were named after my two best mates. One of them was a monkey, and he had some of the shittest takes I'd ever known. It's Rich coming from Gone, of all people, who has arguably the shittest takes. The fuck? You got a gym in your house too? What? Bro, I'm so jealous. Oh, hello, Geary. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're cooking out some delicious food. You ever do to-go audios, Geary? You ever got that to-go going yet? Just wondering. I don't mind. Like, if you probably cook too much food, right? I just thought the biggest limit to your stream is not being able to cook enough. So I thought I could just take some, right? Sounds good, right? You just send it to just DoorDash it to me, you know? Right? That sounds good, right? US gyms are extremely predatory and make it nearly impossible to cancel a membership. Only do a trial with a guest pass. Do not sign up for a month yourself. You're signing up for 6 months at least. Bro, don't worry. I'll be good. Of course, I'll express it to you. Thank you, Yuri. Appreciate it. All right, what's next? John comments on the dark... Oh, this one we were at the Izakaya.
Have you not been following the trash taste subreddit?
Oh, is this you? the other two died, and then I want to do
a stream tomorrow or something where I've only been like half paying attention, but I'm gonna like try to fix the. I'm going to try and like understand. There is apparently a timeline.
I think I saw it.
Oh, this is when I left.
I'll pop in every now and then, and I'm like, oh, interesting. And then when the dark timeline started happening, I went on and was like, where is this?
I don't even know how it started. I just popped up Reddit one week and then.
One episode.
And then the
other two, we have no names, true.
I was like, what is going on? I thought the meme would end there. And I check in a week later.
We're just the other two, dude. Mackie is just oozing Yakuza. Mackie's just very stylish and chill.
That's why I want to like go through like the subreddit to properly understand.
And that was a lie. He didn't do it the next day. He did it like weeks later or a few days later. I don't know. Food poisoning is not an illness. Someone undercooked your beef. You didn't get it by accident. That's true. That's what I'm saying, chat. That's what I'm trying to say. It's not an illness. It's someone fucked up, dude. It's a fucker. I'm still gonna die on this hill, dude. I'm still gonna die on it. I'm telling you, dude. I'm telling you. 1984? Good. Good. Shit take? Bro, I'm standing by this shit. I'm gonna die on this hill for the rest of my life. I don't give a fuck what the doctor says. The doctor doesn't know shit. He's paid by Big Pharma to tell you that, chat. He's paid to tell you that it's an illness, so we can make money. I'm kidding. But my point isn't a joke, though. Isn't it just being poisoned? Yeah, it's being poisoned. If I get bit by a snake and poisoned, I've been poisoned. No, I'm not ill. It's an illness. I haven't caught something. 1 year ago. Now. Wow. Wow. Why does this have so many upvotes? What the fuck? I mean, yeah, I guess. Yeah. Alright. Alright, this one. It's 4 minutes long. Pog, I have to sit back and relax for a bit. Let's go. Pog. But doctor, my favorite streamer says, yeah, tell the doctor he doesn't know shit. What, with 8 years of medical school? Fuck that shit. I have a gut feeling. I first page of Google, baby. All right, I'm kidding. This is not medical advice. Please don't follow my advice. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. I'm dumb as fuck. Thank you. Okay, what's this?
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
What do we have here? It's the condom tree.
God. Oh, Joey.
I'm so excited right now.
This one's a banger. Oh, yeah. Turn it up, Mom. Turn it up.
Okay, it's all the moments from season 2.
I in America.
America, I salute you.
Man, I really want to, like, throw a super chat at this VTuber. Start shooting strangers and they shoot you back.
The fuck? Broad in denial. Okay, what are the deep discussions?
Boneless is better than bones.
You are so wrong!
Like, what's the fucking meaning of life, bro?
I am practically shitty.
The shirt taking off poops are for the poops that, like, fight back.
What is that?
On YouTube.
It's not the lean meat, right? It's the breast. The breast is pure muscle.
I was at house eating Dorito.
I love incest. My fucking penis shriveled up and it just inverted back into my body. 10 kilogram boobs.
They make my heart go pion pion.
What do you think? All the meat is muscle.
Why can I not shit right now?
And then he just kidnaps George Bush.
It's pretzel bread?
Oh. What?
I would gladly be racist. Give me like a plate of broccoli and I put some mayo on that shit and I can just eat it.
Wait, what?
You're still wrong about
the
taste!
You're still wrong too!
You're fucking wrong!
After Dark, yeah, alright, we had good moments in After Dark.
bank of trash.
33 yen.
NGHAW, not no.
NGHAW.
No.
No.
Not my proudest moment.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck, I fucked up. No!
This is Rose Saiyan Goku Black.
I'm just offended.
That's just Black.
He's pretty fucking good.
Goku has another soul in it. It's not Goku. That's it's just Goku by look, but they're two different characters. DZ Newts.
And I give them a hard slap on the face.
Are you French, so you would have been busy eating fucking baguettes?
Why is it lubed? Who lubed this?
This is a German beer, I think.
It could be German. It's either Czech or German.
Two, no. One.
No! No! No!
Hello, weebs!
This time, it's 3,333.
Let's go!
That looks like a fucking American.
One more champ! One more champ!
I'm going to choose a figure that is literally just an ass.
Thank you, Chris Pratt. Thank you so much.
Hello!
Red lights on.
And go! Oh! Oh!
Never doing that again.
Chef Monkey, Chef Karen.
Let's do it.
Yeah, I've definitely done an error.
Oh, no!
I feel like the more I choose something, it slowly releases other flavors in my mouth, so it's good, but...
Oh, Joey! Stop!
It's already dead.
Oh my god.
I can deep throat this. Never had that much meat in my mouth at once, like, just in general, right?
It was really
hard space,
to swallow, wasn't it? It was very hard to swallow.
I like putting it in my mouth.
Yeah.
I don't suck cock every day.
Yeah. Oh, but
my ass was completely numb. I couldn't feel anything. It took such a beating. Oh, oh. If someone could have smacked my ass, I would have known.
What doesn't suck in UK?
I must have decked at least like three kids.
Kids be dumb. He pissed in a snake. Right?
While I was alive?
Have you tasted chicken asshole?
What?
Did you see fucking Bezos' rocket? Right.
He fucking copied me. Should have been my turn.
Now is the time to strike.
These nuts.
I have the problem though that I have short legs, massive ass.
Those fat ass cheeks right there.
Sometimes it's good though. It's no, like it's like beef flavored gum.
No.
What the fuck? I watched an anime.
Boys, get your Twinkies out. All right. Oh, yeah. Touch the tip. There we go.
That's what we're doing, man.
Take one bite.
We've done so much shit, I can't remember
JoJo
it all.
JoJo fans, please stop sucking dick.
Never stop. Please sucking dick.
Not all dicks need to be sucked in the world.
JoJo fans like, what? Impossible.
Damn, that was really good.
We'll see you guys next time.
They should post it to YouTube. I don't know if it is on YouTube, but they should post it to YouTube. That was amazing. Damn, it just makes me forget how much shit we've put out this year. Because After Dark as well, so we have, like, way more shit than normal. Oh my god, dude. It's kind of crazy how much... just how much trash taste content there is now. That was really good. Oh, you gotta upvote that. I forgot to upvote. Okay, I gotta burp, hold on. Oh, Jesus. Oh my god, that was amazing. It was so good. Holy shit. Fuck, it just makes me remember everything that we've done. Dude, we do so much stuff. I do so much stuff that I just forget everything. I'm so glad I have, like, everything in video. Otherwise, I would just forget everything. I would literally forget everything. Will there be more After Dark later this year? Yeah, it'll return when we're back. Damn, that's crazy. That was so cool. Holy shit. I'm so glad we have all of this content, I guess, because I just forget everything, so it's really cool to see it. Goddamn, nice. All right. Even within our 30-second interaction, we could tell Sydney is special. We met pre-COVID. Congratulations to the happy couple. I saw this image the other day, right? And it took me ages to figure out why they were talking about Sydney. Sydney's just standing here. What? Why? What the fuck? Bro, to those of you who have been to AX, this is like the worst hallway to be recognized in. Because it's like the smallest hallway in AX. And it's like, I think it's the only way inside to walk between the two like halls. I don't know if you've been. This fucking hallway sucks. Check comments. Okay. We asked for a picture, but by the time I got my camera pin, Sydney thought we just wanted a picture with the anime zone and hid flat against the wall with her eyes closed. At that point, it was too awkward to ask her to come back. I'm sorry. Usually people just want him. I had food poisoning that day. I hope I didn't seem rude. Excuses. We all know it's not a real illness. Thank you. I don't know why I read this using Connor's voice. The mouse, same. Why? This is the whole thing where Connor said food poisoning isn't an illness. Yeah, Sydney, like, makes herself more awkward. Like, if she thinks she's done something awkward, she snowballs it really fast in real life. If you ever meet her, you might experience it. Like, if she thinks she's done something awkward, she'll be like, she'll freak out. In like a very wholesome way, not like a bad way. She'll just like snowball it. And then she'll commit to it. It's really strange. I'm not poor. Yeah, you should call her poor if you meet her. She'll get super annoyed. It'll be funny as fuck. Dude, this hallway sucks. This hallway sucks at AX. God. I remember I walked around with Aki and Jerry on this hallway one time, and it took us like fucking 30 minutes to walk through this like 2-minute walk hallway. That was back when, God, this was like 2019. So like, I think that was when Jerry, Aki had like blown the fuck up. And people always sit around there as well. Alright, what's this? That's pretty good. Oh shit, I didn't mean to click on it. That's pretty good. Why is there so many me hype videos? A monkey versus madness, dude. Oh my god, man. I realize I just shout all the time. I'm just shouting all the goddamn time. Oh my god, dude. Oh shit, no, this is the thing I opened. Trash taste lore before the earthquake. Oh yeah, pretty good, pretty good. How long does this go on for? I was gonna swap. Yeah, I'm gonna get DMCA'd again. It's true. It got so much more dark and depressing. Hey, but they all went wild with it. They all went wild with it, you know? Oh my god. I like the Chris Alone memes. Those are really funny. Resemblance. It does kind of look like that, doesn't it? That's the IRL height difference, chat. I'm telling you, dude. That's the IRL height difference. Oh my god. Oh, my yawning. Iron Mouse is actual mouse confirmed. True, dude. Connor's Patreon before and after the stripping episode. Oh, God. I'm so bad with Patreon. I've fallen behind so much on it. I've been trying to keep up, but it's so hard for me to do it. But it's like, it's not that I'm even wanted to promote it or anything. It was just kind of like, I was filming that video and I was like, I can't fucking include half of this shit. Because these dudes were just going hard. Literally. They were going crazy. And I was like, well, fuck, I guess I should just put it up on the Patreon so people can see what actually fucking happened. If you've seen it, bro, you know it's wild, dude. Has anyone watched it here? I don't know if people have seen the uncensored version. The video still got desensitized, demonetized? Yeah, it did. I just didn't want it to get age restricted. That's what I was worried about. Because if it gets age restricted, the video is 100% dead. No? Bro, you see everything. You see everything. This is not like an advertisement, but like, there's this one time where the guy's dancing.
Connor, found you through Trash Taste. That has not only been a big source of joy, but a big tool for learning how to better interact with friends, as having autism makes social stuff harder to grasp.
Oh man.
Thank you for everything you've done.
Oh, no worries, man. Wishing you all the best, man. Hopefully, keep getting better and better. Destroy the conversations with ease. You've seen it? Yeah, you see a lot. See a lot. There's like this one time where the guy is dancing and his hand, like on his hand, just using his hand to jump up, and he's literally just wearing like the thinnest thing ever to cover his pee-pee. But you can see everything else. And it's like, Jesus Christ. Being there was a fucking trip. It was like, whoa. 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 There's so much shit that was like, okay. Okay. How much is it to go there? I don't even know. I don't know how much they were charging. What was the name of the main guy again? Seema. He's insane. He's won a ton of awards for like pole dancing competitions. He's so fucking good. It's insane. What is this? When Didus discovers that he can hire a team of highly skilled Japanese animators for basically nothing. Oh no. I did tell him. I was like, if there's any place to hire animators, Didus, it's Japan. You get good animators, just telling you. Not because it was cheap, but I'm just saying, you can get some really good animators. Is Speak of the Devil over? Or did Mouse's internet cut out? What happened? Oh, it crashed? Fuck. Oh no, she's gonna be stressed now because of that. Hope she's okay. Oh, it's so stressful when your internet dies. It's like the most annoying thing. It's like the worst thing that can happen when you're a streamer. Well, no, that's way worse, but I mean, like, during a general stream of nothing crazy, it's so frustrating when it happens. I'm sure she'll be back, guys, who were waiting there. All right, I'm back streaming. I'll be trying to understand the absolute state of the Trash Taste memes. Oh my god, okay, it's happening. Everybody stay calm. Oh god. I died in an earthquake and got reincarnated in another- Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, what is this?
You wanted to know what it was like to go in the shower with the anime man? Well, now you know. It's awkward like this. Not the first time I've been naked on camera, mind you, but certainly a lot more intimate now, isn't it?
The definite worst thing about this part of the video is not that I may possibly get demonetized for my exposed nape, but rather the fact that everyone watching this video now knows about the weird songs I sing in the shower.
Yes, dude. Yes. Fuck yes. Fuck. He did the Skype thing. Our master isn't coming back. What? I love it when Jerry does the Skype. It's so good, chat. Are you telling me it's not amazing? It's so fucking good. It's so good! Oh, I'll just text her quickly. Oh god. Alright. Massive F. Yeah, it's really fucking annoying. Connor, on his way to eat souls of extinct giant tortoises in the afterlife. Bro, if I'm ever on my deathbed, and I get to request a final meal for some reason, I want the giant extinct tortoises. You know, I'm normally against bringing back, dinosaurs and shit, just because, like, Jurassic Park is, I can't even keep a straight face making this joke. I just want to try giant tortoises. Just let me try one. I bet it tastes so good. I bet it tastes amazing, dude. The people in the book documenting, talking about it, man, they just make it sound so good. Yo, Geary, when are you going to make something with a giant tortoise, huh? I'll watch that episode. All right. The two most important episodes in terms of lore? What? Neither thumbnail feature Connor. Curious. Is no one talking about this? Why is no one? I've seen this picture before and I didn't even realize that mistake was there. That's weird. Fair enough. Minor spelling mistake, I win. There you go. Congratulations. Upvote for spelling mistake. Wait, what's this one? Is this the food one? Is this the food one? Which one is this? Trash taste. Have a look, which episode is this? This is episode... We can't stop arguing 56. This is where we talk about boneless chicken. All chicken tastes the same argument.
Chicken tastes the same, Joey?
Yeah, okay. I guess those two are the most important in terms of trash taste lore. Well, you don't really need to watch this one. Because... The whole point is that we didn't survive an earthquake, which doesn't happen in the video. It's just the thumbnail, I guess, or the idea. I don't really know. It seems very complicated. Dream. Wait, hold on. What's this? When you like incest, that's okay. When I like NTR and Ugly Bastards, everyone freaks out. That doesn't seem fair. That's funny. It's true. I mean, listen, I don't know why Ugly Bastard feels so gross. I don't know. Ugly Bastard and NTR is weird. I guess because incest feels like... I don't know why. When Gant's like, I like incest, I'm like, well, I know Gant doesn't actually want incest. But then Ugly Bastard is like, but what if you're attracted to that? I don't know. Wincest? I don't know why Gant likes incest, though. I mean, I don't think it's real, but... I mean, I know it's not real, but it's just a meme at this point, I guess. Alright, this is the end stream wheel.
Please not end stream!
It took me so long to end the stream after this point. I just didn't know what to do. I didn't expect it. I just... I don't know. I was kind of processing it all. I was like, do I really want to end? But then I realized I had to commit. I had to commit to the bit. I couldn't... If I say no, then I'm kind of... What's the point of having it there, right? I was running through the options in my head of what I should do. And I just came to the conclusion of, it's just better if I end it. It makes more sense. Checking in the sub as a non-frequent visitor. What the hell happened here? I am a frequent visitor, and even I was confused. So, I don't know if that helps much.
One second, let's see if Matt.
Now we slightly understand Gant's pain, thanks to the dark timeline. Then why do your eyes look like this? Oh my god, dude. Sad Gant. It's such an iconic face, dude. It's such an iconic face now. I just can't not see sad Gant anymore now. Anytime Gant's sad, I just think about it. Just Gant being sad, you know? Just... sad. Gant got a premonition. Yeah, he did. Maybe he got a... Yeah, he must have got a premonition during the episode. That's the only thing that makes sense. Why would somebody go that sad for no reason? Shit's so funny. Holy shit. Oh my god, dude. Please tell me I'm not alone when I thought the new Doctor Strange movie was boring as fuck. Me hoping the other boys like it for the sake of another major debate. Dude, Marvel fanboys are the fucking worst, dude. I realized they have like no brain cells. They just blindly support that movie. And then they were like, oh, why did you go and watch it then? If you know. Here's the argument they use. They're like, well, the ticket sales are so good. So clearly it can't be that bad. And I'm like, what? How is that even remotely a good argument? I had to pay to see it. I wanted to see it. And then I didn't like it. So I've contributed to the success of the movie. The success doesn't mean any bearing on whether it's good or not. Marvel movies will always do well. It could be the shittest movie ever, and it will do well. I'm pretty sure the fucking straight-to-DVD fucking Black Widow film did well money-wise. How is that a fucking a benchmark? Critics loved it. Yeah, I don't give a shit what the critics think. I came out the movie. I was bored as shit. It's just boring. Doctor Strange is boring, dude. I don't know. It's just Benedict Cumberbatch being British for like 2 hours, and it's just not British. He's American. Sorry. Benedict Cumberbatch being snarky for like 2 hours, and it's like, oh wow, okay. Okay, I get it. All right. It's just Sherlock with a fucking American accent half the time. It's just like, god damn it. It's just everything has to be a quip. Everything has to be funny. He has to be a smartass to everything. And then the CG was good, and the fights were just so boring. I don't even know what the fuck is going on in the fights. My least hated trope in movies is like when two people shoot beams at each other, and the beam means fucking nothing. The beam literally means fuck all. It's the laziest way of like making a fight where you just have two beams shooting at each other, and they did it like a few times, and I'm just like, it's just like, I don't give a fuck. The music fight was dumb as shit. If you haven't watched it, don't worry. I'm not spoiling anything major. There's not really much to spoil anyway. The music fight was just dumb. I hated the music fight. Where did that come from? I don't know. Connor, who hurt you? It just feels like to me, okay, I don't know if this is a fair statement to say, but it feels like to me that Marvel movie watchers don't watch any other movies in the cinema. And I feel like it shows. I feel like they have no other perspective of what other films are like, other than like other Marvel films and other superhero films. It just feels like they don't go to the cinema to watch anything that isn't a superhero movie. So I don't know. I go to the cinema all the fucking time. I watch a lot of movies, and like compared to a lot of the movies that came out like last year, even Doctor Strange was boring. Feelings in the silliest ways, including me, including you. True. That's why it's so important to sometimes chill when it comes to opinion. Yeah, I don't know. I don't mind if people enjoyed it. I'm not saying you can't enjoy it. I'm just saying I thought it was boring. And if you enjoyed the film, good man. I'm glad you could enjoy it, but I just didn't. I just, yeah. And a lot of people were like, oh, you had to have watched WandaVision to get it. And I'm like, what? Like, I understand what's going on. I don't have the brain of a four-year-old. I can figure out that she lost the guy that she liked and doesn't have kids. It's not that hard to figure out. Like, I don't... Like, people acting as if, like, this is, like, some kind of crucial point. Like, it's very obvious what is... The story makes complete sense without watching it. You know what I mean? Like, spoiler, I haven't even watched WandaVision. I don't even know if that's true. If it's a spoiler, I just guessed that. I don't know. I hate this justification of, oh, well, you clearly don't enjoy it because you haven't watched 19 other properties. And it's like, what? What do you listen to yourself? Do you hear this? You sound like a madman. I hate it. I hate it, dude. So I'm just, yeah, I don't know. Now this is taking up stream time. The plot is predictable. True.
I just watched the Spelling Bee episode. Whore, the way you spelt it is a Welsh word. If you were on a Welsh Spelling Bee, you would have gotten
thanks, man.
Cheese curds.
They kind of ignored WandaVision. It's just everyone had their excuses to why I was wrong or why I would have liked it if I had something else. Like, if I'd watched Shields of whatever the fuck it is, season 2, episode 6. Like, what
have
are you talking
seen
about?
Everything Everywhere All at Once.
I haven't yet. It wasn't in cinemas in Japan. I wanted to, though. I don't know. I just don't want to watch that shit. I'm gonna be honest. I don't want to. I feel like Marvel just milks the fans for like every screen time they can get them, and I'm just like, I just don't want to. A lot of the stuff just doesn't interest me. It seems really boring. I don't care about this side character who had 1 second in Infinity War. I don't really care. Some fans are dying for this. I don't. If they want it, I mean, good for them. But I have the right to be like, this movie was boring as fuck without them losing their mind. Oh, man. All right, rant over. All right, me casually looking at the Trash Taste Awards. Finding out the meme I made got into the awards. Congratulations, man. Thank you for using a meme to express your joy. Because we watched it in 3D. Yeah, maybe I wouldn't have been bored if I watched it in 3D. I just watched it in normal D. Normally. After the accident, they needed new members. It's what he always dreamt of, but never like this. Are you an official Trash Taste member?
Wait,
yes. What do they cost?
Going to
everything.
Be able to enjoy Trash Taste anymore if I don't fully understand the dark timeline.
No, you can.
Are
you can.
Sure, this isn't the worst timeline. I mean, in the dark timeline, mm-hmm. at least Connor was a MILF.
Wait, I have two of those? Wait, hold on. Wait, no, oh, wait, no, different one. Wait. Yeah, here we go. I was a what? He would never say that, but if he did, I'd imagine I'd still watch him. My first time seeing Connor when watching podcast. The English broke my head. My first time seeing Connor when watching podcast for first time. Oh my god, that's so fucking loud. Shut up. Oh my god. Who the fuck is that guy? Me now. I'm gonna be streaming for 10 hours straight, so be there in 10 minutes, bitch. At your service, my king. Oh my god. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. I think, yeah, I mean, it was definitely the least known when Trash Taste started, so... It's done a lot of wonders for me. I think a lot of people know. Very true. Welcome, chat. Welcome to the stream, chat. I'm surprised so many of you turn up. Who the fuck is Connor? True. I like how they found a who the fuck is Connor while with a Connor meme. Nice. Very nice. Oh, Mouse is trying to come back. She just told me. God damn, her internet
Connor,
must have fucked her today.
There is an edit on the sub of Mouse on the Broom in the long drive with the Harry Potter theme. It's called Year Wizard Mouse.
Oh, really? Has it been upvoted a lot? I hope it has. Damn. I appreciate all the support, the growth in every one of my ventures, if you will, has been insane the past 2-3 years. Especially, like, Trash Taste just kind of kicked everything off, and Trash Taste blew up. And then I feel like a lot of my stuff blew up. And yeah, again, I'm always really grateful for it, guys. I always say this, but yeah, thank you so much, man. I'm always grateful for the growth. Like, the fact that we have 11K viewers right now is nuts. And the fact that we got like 20K viewers during the Sabathon at one point. Like, yeah, it's just nuts. I really appreciate it. Like, I didn't have a schedule. I didn't tell you guys I was streaming today. You guys just turned up. And I really appreciate that. I should be better and tell you guys, though. I'm sorry. Okay, what is this? Sydney realizing that she married a handsome man instead of an ugly bastard. Good meme. I love that one. I love this meme too. Good memes. Oh, dude, this shit. Oh, hold on. Stop. I think this is a continuation of the art that we saw earlier from this guy, I think. Is it? Yeah, it is. So this left off. Callie came in. Sorry to interrupt, but I can't let my friends kill each other now. And then they fight. And then Crony joins in. Oh, this is before. Wait, no, what? Oh my god, okay, I'm reading it out of order. Oh, Jesus. Let's look at it anyway. I would like to turn back. I'm gonna have to stop you right there. That little request which you desire has millions of consequences. I'm well aware of that. Even so, I must go back in time so I can save them. I'll do whatever it takes to bring back our times together. Dude, this crony art is so sick, dude. I'm afraid you weren't listening to me. I must ask that you leave or else. I was hoping it didn't have to come to this, but... here I go. Bro, this is so sick, dude. It's over 2 years since you boys were gone. I'll do my best to overcome this and bring you guys back. If I don't, Joey and Connor, maybe I'll finally join you guys together. Dude, it's so sick, dude. Let me get to this guy's profile. Hopefully he hasn't got anything crazy on his profile. Don't want to out him. Oh, he's drawn so much art. Oh, this one was cool as well. He drew a dark timeline in Connor Saga featuring Iron Mask. This one looks sick. He's teasing it. So there must be another one, right? Crazy. Oh, this is the one I saw. This is this one. Are he posted this as well? Oh my god. Some posts. He's in chat. Hello. Your art is insane. Oh, you did this one too? This one's sick as well. Look at this one. This one's so sick. You guys can't see it. Oh my god. Crazy. Okay. This one. Is it this? This is it. I'm sorry, Sydney, but I have to do this. Don't do it, God, please, I'm begging you. I'm sorry, I must bring them back. And then we have Crony down here.
I found my air pump.
Thank you. Dude, amazing work, man. Keep it there. Up, dude.
Now my
keep it up.
Ego is almost as inflated as Connor's okay.
Gone in the bicycle timeline. What the fuck is this from? What the fuck? What is this anime from? Golden Boy? This looks insane. What? What the fuck? Is a classic. Please watch it. I'm sold by just this. Oh my god. Holy shit. Dude, this looks so fucking good. Holy fuck. Oh my god. I gotta watch this show. Gotta watch the dub. Is the dub good or something? Alright, I guess I know what I'm watching on the plane then. Damn. Way better. The dub is hilarious. Oh shit. Okay. Golden Boy. I gotta download that. Alright, people voting for Chris for best trip. People voting for Chris for worst trip. People who voted for Chris for best trip and worst trip. Well, he won both. Dr. Ligma coming to help God fix the timeline. When did Dr. Ligma become a beam?
I randomly found you from a clip called Nyanna's Wants to Punch Connor, not knowing nor caring what a VTuber was, but I had to know why they wanted to punch you. Been a fun 8 months.
Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate it. Finish the clip? Oh, is it? Okay. So fucking dumb, dude. The entire world about to forget the Trash Day's dark timeline. Oh my god, dude. I'm here to talk about the Trash Taste Initiative. Yeah, that does seem like Maylene's alley. Alright, what's this? Connor and Jerry's ghost when Gant takes his PT. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus, dude. Oh, no. Oh, no. Poor Gant. And this is one of the timeline universes. Oh, God, no. This thing is so cursed. I don't know why she got this made. This is so fucking cursed. I can't look at it. I can't look at it. It's so creepy. Code Geass has the best ending of all time. Me who knows it's Trash Taste episode 39. I made it for her. I know, but it's so cursed. Jesus, dude. It's so cursed. Why did Nina do it? What happened, dude? What happened? Jesus, dude. It's creepy. Alright. I'm sure this message is read by the most beautiful girl in the world. Hello, Connor. It's her mom. Alright, by the way. I came looking for copper, and I found gold. Oh, God, dude. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Trash Taste Boys coming back from the UK. Trash Taste Boys. The subreddit. Connor and Jerry died. Well, Gant was in the UK. Me and Jerry have just been watching it like, bruh, like... Okay. Jesus. Oh. They're finally together. This JoJo meme is one of my favorites. Wait, I think I, hold on.
Hey, where is it? I have it somewhere.
Boys. Are you really one of the boys if you don't have one of these? You really one of the boys if you don't have a Polaroid? You really one of the boys? My prized possession. I actually want to frame it. It's just been on the floor. But something's been covering it, so ironically it's in like the best. My pride at JoJo merch. The boys. The boys. 69 missed, damn. I'd fucking love this thing, it's so cool. I need to get a frame for it. Get it signed? Bro, if I got it signed by Araki, dude. Fuck, dude, life goals, dude. Life goals. Sign that with Araki, bro. It would be my prized possession. It would, dude. Don't even get me started, dude. Trying to understand the Dark Timeline series. Me. This is a complete clusterfuck. How did this get so out of control? Trash Taste subreddit. Dark Timeline lore. I literally have no idea. God. Kaho going through every time to be a regular everywhere.
It's been a while since I've seen Code Geass, but I remember that Nina was really fond of tables.
Yeah, she is. She is. She likes her tables. Can't read. Kaho going through every time and to be regular everywhere. Can't read. What? I can't read. What? I thought I read that correctly. Am I crazy? Kaho going through every timeline to be regular everywhere. Not very... I said something different? Oh, okay. I'm dumb. Streamer brain. Woke up. Alpha Treasure, I fell off. I'm old. Okay, another video. Pog. Oh my god. Oh shit. Let me...
Yes? Trash taste?
It was beautiful.
It looks so cursed, dude. That's a good one. That's a good one, bro. I like that. I like that. That one's funny. Oh shit, sorry. Gant used to work at the BBC. Jerry and Connor used to work at Trash Taste.
Okay, this one seems bruh. Alright, let me look at this timeline first.
So I guess, 7 minutes I guess long.
This is like the original timeline. Where it's like my original timeline. This is literally me going through Fate Lore. This is like me trying to piece together the timelines. Alright.
Reddit within
when
Reddit.
He stops taking
this
pills,
is Redditception.
I don't know what you're talking about. That's like I said, I just saw Jerry and Connor the other day. Gant is imagining the multiverse of Trash Taste, and Dark Timeline is one of them. Now that was
does it just get more progressively insane?
I will say, I think this is a bit too easy to fuck.
What is this? What?
Wait, I've got to compare. Like, we might be in the original timeline. We're not in the original timeline. No, we are in the original. Fuck no.
Please touch grass instead of making these memes. Timeline. Hey, they're good memes. They're pretty good.
All right. So we go back to the fucking hell. First of all, what the actual fuck? What the actual fuck is this? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. I haven't even scratched the surface. I haven't even fucking scratched the
surface. It didn't feel that complicated. Am I crazy?
Oh god. How fucking long does this take? What? What the fuck is that? So that's what the Fate universe looks like.
Oh no, not Fate, dude.
Trash Taste lore is officially on par with the Fate timeline lore now.
You skimmed it? What do you mean? I went through the entire thing.
Holy shit. We start off at the beginning.
You found a Google Doc with all the timelines? Oh my god, there's even more.
Start from the BBC timeline. There's a BBC timeline? Yeah, I don't get what these timeline memes are all about.
There is a Google Doc? Oh my god.
Same. All right, you got Trash Taste episode 1.
Are they all added together?
And you go all
the way. There's a bigger one? I thought I read the biggest one.
Fukushima earthquake where Connor and Jerry died in the 16th of March 2022. And then Garn develops his mental illness. Am I still alive?
Send me the biggest one, Road.
What is... Where am I in this timeline? Am I just like... Oh, I'm just crazy. And we go back... Oh, so the Trash Taste timeline is... So I started here, where...
Let's see how... I want to skip ahead and see how insane Rob gets. Okay, I broke it.
That's the dank timeline, okay.
There's a dank timeline?
JCM helps Sydney save Grant. Who is JCM? Oh, Joseph Connor Manny Tapper. Oh, of course, I should have known that. What is this one?
What is this?
Oh no.
Oh my god. Hold on.
Hey, I just met you. And this is crazy.
Honestly, that timeline has so many issues, not the least of which is the idea that Connor died in 2022. Clearly, he's been hanging with Satan for like a year and a half.
I've never seen a picture load like that slow. Oh my god. What? How far can I zoom in on this? Oh my god. There's so much. Oh my god. Look how long this is. I thought I read the timeline. What is this? Why is there so much? What? How does this... Why? This is too much. This is too much. What is your source? I just made it the fuck up. What is this over? Like, this is the zoomed out version. This is insanity. Council Alliance. This is so long. Dude, the image is so big that it stutters. This is insane. Who had this much time? This is insanity. I feel like they're just chucking everything in the subreddit. Why is this here?
Wasn't that complicated, he says Pepe laugh.
Why is the back rooms here? Why is the back rooms here? What the actual fuck, dude? The back rooms are just casually here. What the fuck is this? What? Chris and Joey awake in the bed. Why are we in the back rooms? The pair wander the back rooms, narrowly avoiding death many times and traversing its various levels. Joey, still depressed and mentally ill, starts hallucinating. Trash taste on the wall. Chris is separated from Joey. Chris continues to wander the back rooms alone. Joey's fate. Joey goes mad in the back rooms, becoming Killer Chris. Well, I thought he became Killer Chris in a different timeline. So Killer Chris becomes in the broad timeline and continues this one. This is the one that we saw earlier. All right, so Killer Chris in the timeline that I read was different. Joey, although separated from Chris, manages to survive in the back rooms. His mind fading, Joey stumbles upon a mysterious level of the back rooms. A tropical island over infinite void. The voices keep Joey. Joey jumps into the void. The void consumes Joey. The jelly's born. Why? And then Chris finds an exit back that uses to solve the mystery gauntlet. The Gaunt Rumentality. Gaunt Rumentality? The fuck does that even mean? What does that mean? What does that mean? Oh, Fillion, thank you for the big raid. Holy shit, thank you so much. Thank you. I don't know how to explain what I'm doing right now. What were you up to? I hope it was
this melts
fun.
My small turtle brain.
And then we have the Council of Giga timeline. This is just too much. What is this down here in the corner? There's something in the corner. This timeline hurts my brain. Oh, okay, so someone made it. Oh my god. Thank you so much for the raid. I appreciate it. I hope you guys had a fun stream. I don't know what you guys are up to. I'm currently reading the Trash Taste Law. If you don't know what it looks like, here's what it looks like. No! This is psychotic! This is like... This is just mental breakdown fuel. How can anyone watch this? How can you follow this? Okay.
Which is worse, Gaunt not being able to let go of Joey and Connor, or Connor refusing to accept that he died and instead continues to stream as a ghost?
This is an r/place. Jesus Christ. Who understands the law? Hands up if you understand the law.
With infinite time and relentless determination can achieve.
Does anybody understand the law? Hands up if you understand. Me. Why are you lying? Why are you lying in the chat? You don't understand the law. You don't understand. Look at this shit. What is this? There's the dark dimension. What even is this? What is the dark dimension? The time machine malfunctions, causing... What?
People need to touch some damn grass.
No. Listen. People do need to touch grass in general. But this is... I admire the amount of work gone into this. Imagine, these are the kinds of people who in 5 years will be making flying cars because they were somehow able to keep track of this stuff. We can't comprehend this with our normal human brains. This is flying car level brains, chat. We are very lucky what we're witnessing right now. This is truly the apocalypse. Okay, the Gaunt who eats crust is in the timeline. What the actual fuck? There's a doomsday ending. Sigma Gaunt is here. How do you even make room for all of
Knuckles
this?
Cracked, gamer headset on, meds not taken.
The end is never ending. The end is never ending. Me going insane. I'm glad that image of me is getting some mileage. Okay, the Dr. Ligma timeline, which of course is a thing. Okay, Kaho and Felix are there. What the actual fuck? This is just too much. This is too much lore. I think we have had enough lore! Stop! I can't keep up!
In the Dr. Ligma timeline, Achilles is replaced by his brother, Bofidius. Instead of
Achilles!
His weakness is Bofidius nuts.
You know when I said it was easy to follow? This one made it so much harder. This one is so much harder to follow. I can't do it.
Balls to the wall with lore and alternate timelines. Now you have to have a PhD in trash taste to watch.
Just fucking read it chronologically. Just read it chronologically. Yeah, okay. Yeah, where do I start,
this guy
huh?
He's not a clown, not a circus. He's an entire circuit board.
Chronologically. Oh, just read it top left. Okay, yeah. Okay, sure. Yeah. Top left. All right. Okay, we go down. Okay, there's already like 15 fucking diverging timelines. And then when do I follow which timeline when? What do you mean just chronologically? There's nothing chronological about this. This is not chronological. This is a mess. How do I keep up with this? This is insanity.
The law never ends. 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 The law never.
Just wait for Netflix to adapt it. Yeah, I'll wait for the Netflix adaptation. I need an explainer video. Can somebody please make an explainer video? I need an explanation.
Meme is actually hitting the front page of the sub. I'd be honored for you to review the We Must Reach Trash Taste video.
I'll try my best. Let's continue on with the memes. So how's your day going? Oh wait, I need to just... Oh my god.
As a fake fan, I'm confused too. It's okay, Connor.
Good. Way too dank. Alright. Felix came here, very pog. My contribution to the Dark Lore, my magnum opus. It's a pretty cool poster. Bro, this one's sick. This art is sick. Gaunt Lactus, the devourer of timelines. Dude, this is such a good fucking piece of art.
This is what I picture when I think about the Fate series.
There's a new Dark Timeline set in the Superliminal called Taken for Granted. It's too much.
There is new Dark Timeline trailer set in Superliminal called Taken for Granted.
How do I find this? Okay. Why is it Superliminal? It's pretty cool though. Sounds sick. Alright, me thinking Gaunt hates crust because he has bad food takes, me realizing Gaunt hates crust because Earth's crust caused earthquakes. Oh my god. Sydney, I just like reading NTR. It has no relation, no real life. Also Sydney, I put my fingers down her throat. William describes Sydney. So we're all in the bathroom and she was
fine. That timeline is like the Google map. If you zoom in more, you will find more tiny lines in between the tiny dots. Nano dots in between nano lines.
Nano machines. Dark timeline gone. Mediating full episode of trespass.
Timeline where Joey and Chris actually switch places and Connor is actually American.
No, that sounds awful. And that's what we did. Crazy, right? Insane. Bullshit. I have no personal experience with that at all, so it's bullshit. Oh no, he's talking to himself. No! Connor and every guy in chat after hitting his balls. Mouse and every girl in chat. Listen, it's a serious... Dude, they don't understand, dude. They don't understand, alright? It's a serious pain. It's no joke. It is an epidemic. It doesn't make any sense for me to label it as such, but it is, dude. I'm telling you. It's a severe problem. Oh my god. Jaw chuckles. I'm in danger. I long for a man. Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay, just my tweet. What's this? First resurrection. Podcast after the resurrection of Jerry and Connor. What the fuck? No. Oh my god, dude. It's so good. Let me watch it again. The sound design is so good. Oh my god, dude. Rengoku. What?
Let me see the fate.
Rengoku dying in the back. Oh, anyway. They were just playing anime in the back, and I didn't have the balls to be like, hey, could you put something else on? So I just left it. I was like, it doesn't matter that much. Rengoku just dying in the background while everyone's fucking stripping. This shit was so fucking funny, dude. Spoilers, bro, come on. You should have watched it by now. Alright, what's this? Gant realized at the time.
Timeline quickly. What is what the fuck is that? Wait, that wasn't even as
why fun. Does it feel like the dark and trash taste timeline just feel like fake Ilyaverse and the Miiverse? In order words, we should have a Garnt universe, Garnuverse, inside of the trash taste universe, TT verse, all of the possibility of mighty Garnt.
All right, so that's like the fate timeline.
Okay.
So we compare. Fucking hell. So that's what the fate universe looks like. Alright, it is on the same level as the fate timeline. He's gonna cry
when he sees the new timeline. He's gonna cry. POV, your trash taste staff wiping the office windows. True. My favorite anime is Odd Taxi. You're as beautiful as the day I lost you. Oh, that's right, yeah, she retired, right? Yeah, cause I can't remember when Joey asked us to do the thing. It was months ago, though. A long time ago. Hey, John. Isn't that like permanent hiatus, right? Right? Am I crazy? It's over now, right? Am I crazy? Hiatus, not retired? Oh, I thought it was retired. Indefinite hiatus means retired in Japan. I mean, it means retired normally. Yeah, that's sad. Damn. Kind of reading about how England colonized Wales, bro. Tough time, man. It was a tough time. The South got fucked, man. The South got fucked hard. Oh, they're so goddamn English now. The sub being parasocial as fuck, thinking they deserve some wedding content for some reason. I understand, right? Obviously, you want the wedding, but yeah, it's obviously, we're not going to. I'm sure we'll post pictures or something, but ain't no videos happening, no content happening. Thanks for coming to my wedding, everyone. Sag, dude, Sag. Affable, oh, this one, we've already seen this meme. You know it's bad food take when the king of giving bad food take says it's a bad food take? My hot food take of the month, I don't really like the sauce they put on okonomiyaki. On takoyaki, and all gyoza taste the same to me. But all gyoza taste the same? Oh, dude. All gyoza does not taste the same. What are you on about, Emily? An okonomiyaki sauce is like a bomb. What the fuck? Emily's really strange with food. She's like really open to everything, and then she'll just have like one really weird dislike that I don't understand. Really bizarre. Just sharing a shower thought I had today. Vanilla gone. I know every fate timeline. Time traveler gone. I know every fate timeline in every timeline. Can't wait to see them all on the podcast. They're known as the Big Three. I'm glad you guys all like the Dieters episode. People seem to love it. Gone, aka Dark Timeline Gone, invades the original timeline. Finally, a timeline where they are still alive. Gone, Manitabo, die, so I can take your place in this world. That's just the motivation of the WandaVision woman. I forgot her name. It was just so mid, I forgot. Learns Photoshop to edit photos. Learns Photoshop to make an absolute trash... to make absolute trash memes. Dude, that's such a good edit. Fucking great. Great edit. Great edit. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. I love this meme. Makes two scripts and films one of them. Film multiple second channel videos. Streamed 3 times. Recorded multiple trash taste episodes. Did all within a week. Leaves to get married. Giga Chad shit, eh? Giga Chad. Amazing. Non-regulars on the Reddit asking for the source of the dark timeline memes. Trash taste lore experts. My source is that I made it the fuck up. It's true. All of this is just utter nonsense, but at least it's fun. It's fun to explore what goes on in your guys' unstable universe. In your unstable thoughts. It all makes sense now. Gant suddenly turning sad. Moments are just memories from his counterparts from the different timelines. Slipping through the cracks in the multiverse, created by Gant going back in time. That is one reason. That is one reason. Let us live? No, no, no. It's awesome. Connor stream goes badunkut. What? Badunkus? Chat be like, new lore just dropped. Oh my god. Gant can't get over what happened to the boys meanwhile. Very true, true. Oh my god. When you invest 100 yen on a hat with weird English and end up winning Vest Drip because of it. No! I just need to yawn. I'm so sleepy, chat. He won the best and worst drip, though, so he gets no award, right? It cancelled out, right? Right? Dark Timeline Gant trying to discover time travel to bring the boys in Sydney back. Lubricated Among Us Test 98. That's so fucking good. Holy shit. Gant just testing on lubed Among Us, hoping for some results. Alright, go home, everyone. Stream's okay, haunted.
Sure, let's do it. Let's do it.
The fuck are you? It does look really funny when Iron Mouse is just looking up in the corner. It's so fucking funny to me. Curb your end stream.
You guys want stream ends?
I've already seen this, but here's the...
I'll do it.
Here's the long version.
I'm gonna put end stream.
Gotta relive this shit again.
End. Stream. If this happens, I'm not coming back to you, alright? That's it.
If we man of my word, chat.
It's done.
Hey, Connor. 20 minutes later. I think you
let's do,
will
a,
like.
Let's do a practice spin just okay. So we can get a feel for it. You know what I mean? Alright, ready?
Same shirt? No, different shirt, different shirt.
By the way, we're just practicing. End stream. Okay, actually, you know what, guys?
1 hour later.
It's a different shirt. This doesn't have pocket.
No. Why? I trolled. Please not end stream.
Me again. Someone donated to send me these. These are recent posts, so they're not going to come up. But let's have a look. There's a trash taste in 10 seconds. It's posted 19 hours ago. Wow, that's crazy. Like seeing how much the middle camera angle changes in the first few episodes is nuts. And then even in the second season, it still nudges a little bit here and there. Yeah, because it like wasn't centered for a while, right? Then we centered it a little bit more. Wow. And then apparently, this came out yesterday. Top 50 most spoken words by the boys, season 2. Alright, what do you think the most spoken word is, chat? What do you think? You've already seen it. Alright. The most spoken word on Trash Taste is... fucking. Jesus Christ. Okay, let me try and... Alright, so it's... fucking. Yeah, I can't say it for some reason. Fucking. And then kind is second. That's shocking. Kind, gunner, shit, fuck, remember, Japan, literally, stuff, anime, maybe, watch, probably, guys, pretty, guy, Japanese, weird, taste, guess, wanna, Chris, Joey, video, movie, trash, Gant, exactly, episode, food, watching, course, 10, wait, cool, trying, bit, obviously, basically, saying, talking, fun, story, talk, YouTube, Connor, definitely, reason, amazing, and watched. Wow. I'm surprised at how much more we say fucking than anything else. But I guess that's what happens. Oh my god. Jesus. We said I 70,000 times. And like 52,000 times. Holy shit. It, the, you, that, and, a, two. Oh my god. How did he make this? I'm back again this year with a bunch of graphs representing the frequency of which certain words are said. Changes since last year. No graph for regular episodes. Stream combined for the sake of reducing the number of graphs. 9 graphs last year confused everyone. If once them, let me know, I can make the minimal effort. These graphs only include the season's episodes starting from, but not including the last award show. Last year, they had only been like 4 streams, so this year, rather than just taking the streams of the year, I'm just using all the streams. Next year, I'll probably only include the streams of that year. Specifically, for the 24-hour stream, since the whole stream is on YouTube, I can't count the words. The individual segments are included. I combine the two filtering methods. As a reminder, I'm filtering by frequency and by stop word. So if a word is said to... too frequently in the English language, i.e. the, it would have been filtered out. A stop word are mundane words that are often filtered out in language processing. I manually filtered out the words yeah, okay, and oh, since they were getting filtered out before. I raised the allowed frequency specifically because before I was filtering out the word shit. Wow. That's insane. How do you make this? That's so insane. Just nuts. Just the amount of effort is insane. When you scroll through the funny meme lore, when you realize Gant hates crust, it's because the Earth took everything from him. Jesus. This is proof that we have, the final proof that we need to confirm that we are on the dark timeline. Oh god. Gant mentions that in a video, of course he does. Trash Taste After Dark. Trash Taste After Darkest Timeline. Oh my god. That's such a creepy image of me. Holy shit, dude. Trash Taste 2M after... Another dark timeline. Gant's wedding. You may kiss the bride. Nervous. Kiss her for the boys. Kiss her for the boys. Smooch. Pog. Yeah, that's exactly how it's going to go. I think that's how it's all going to go down, chat. It's exactly how it's going to go down. A thought came across me while streaming through the dark timeline. Me reading through the timeline... Trash Taste Dark Timeline Lore memes. Me realizing that I'm living through my own country's darkest timeline. Aww. No, bro. Joey tries to reason with Dark Timeline Gant, of course. Gant. Don't try and stop me, Joey. Destroying anime won't bring me back, mate. Jesus Christ. Out of everyone, I thought you'd understand. If anime is gone, you and Connor wouldn't be in Japan when the earthquake hits. Connor, Aki, Chris, and I are gone.
We're gone. Without anime, there would be no trash taste. No boys. Stop, gone. Everyone's suffered enough. You've suffered enough. Just let us sleep. It's too late, Joey. I've eaten too many crusts to stop. Everyone says it's impossible, but I'm a gacha player. I know how to beat the odds. Gaunt, no. But then Gaunt dies. Okay. What in the actual fuck is all this? Gaunt, when he finds out, finds the one that was killing the boys and ruining his life. So fucking dumb, Jesus, dude. Another trailer, alright.
Charles, the world is not the same as it was.
It's monkey.
Mutants. They're gone now.
I hurt myself.
DMCA, DMCA, DMCA.
To see if I still feel.
I'll just mute it.
Needs our help.
You are someone to come along.
Someone has come along.
I am still right here.
Try my best here, boys. I'm trying my best here, boys. It's just Logan, right? It's just Logan. Connor, Sabathon happens, Mouse. That's a nice tummy you got there. It'd be a shame if someone raised it. Appreciate it, Mouse. Thank you. Way of the House Monkey? True, dude. My new life. From a boy to a man. Gaunt's glow up. Gaunt lies naturally as he breathes. The best anime I've ever seen is Full Metal Alchemist.
I don't enjoy
but
eating the crust.
But you're making it tasteless by only eating the crust. Tasteless part till last. I don't enjoy but eating the crust. You're making it tasteless by only eating the crust.
Me dancing in my room while my mom and dad are arguing. That's so good, dude. My father ordering McDonald's. 6-year-old me asking for a Happy Meal. That's good. I like that one. But you guys actually want to see the wedding? I thought it was a joke. That's funny. Top 3 most viewed episodes of Trash Taste Season 2. Not surprising that the Chris ones are there. And the figure special, obviously.
You can... I don't...
Did the camera just literally cut to Joey so we could see him sniffle?
Special menu can they provide?
You can get, like, the... You can... I don't...
Special menu can they provide?
You can get like the you can I don't why you know what probably happened if I had to guess Mudan probably did it by looking at the audio waves and probably thought that, like, they said something there, or, like, Joey said something, and probably just cut it in without looking or watching it. Oh, Mudan explains it in the comments. I don't know. Mudan was making a point to Joey. Oh, Mudan's here. Compliments. Yeah, it was intentional. I keep in moments that are fun or weird or different to keep it interesting because I know people will meme them. There's some very weird parts I cut away, although you'd never know. Everything is edited manually using a multicam in Premiere, so all the camera angles changes are done by a person. Usually I have someone to do most of the angles and I review it all and change adjust if necessary. Oh wow, we did it on purpose. What a fucking big brain. That's so fucking funny. That shit's so funny, dude. Holy shit. Congrats on hitting an episode 100. Dude, this is sick, fan art. Nice, dude. Amazing. Mouse took over Connor's stream. Now we have this. Hi, guys. I'm Amos. Hi, guys. I'm C-Dog. Who would win? $1,000 jacket, polite lad with a hat.
Could have been me. Meanwhile, another universe. What the fuck? Oh, I saw this. I haven't seen it all, but Chris sent it to me.
Welcome back to the Chris Abroad channel. I'm on a wacky weekend with Connor, C.VA.
Why is it that every time I see you, the weather is just awful?
When I envisaged this whole wacky weekend thing, I thought, oh, we're going to experience the culture. And all you want to do is Love Hotel.
Are you ready to make babies?
Oh, that's absolutely horrific.
It seems that you need some cosplay in your life. Get that wig. Put on those clothes. What are you waiting for? This is the perfect moment to show off your ass.
Seems this world.
You're feeling bad, bad result. Basically drinking pure soy sauce. Look
at me. Moku no chin chin oki desu.
Oh my god.
Oh no. Oh no, dude, how much are you pouring? Oh. That is battery. That is paint. I'm being a little bitch. I'm being a little bitch, Chris.
What a person.
I'm glad I was, because Chris was obliterated.
Why did we drink so much last night? I feel like we just wasted everything.
You're an idiot.
I'm going to take you to what was one of the best hotels in North Japan.
Where have you taken us, Chris? We're going to die tonight. Chris, this is not what I signed up for.
I've got white shoes, Chris. White. Let's leave now. Oh, I can't take this shit no more.
This is really well done. This is really well done. Holy shit.
Next time it's going to be the most unpleasant boat. The worst plane in Japan. Crashing into a volcano. Iron Mouse, do you like Pinocchio?
I fucking hate Pinocchio.
Yeah!
Alright, nice. That was fucking well edited. That was awesome. That was amazing. I said it, dude. People who understand Trash Taste Law, people who watch the Rick and Morty, people who understand Fate Law. Evil Gaunt assassinated by the Council of Gaunts. What? What? It's been a long day without you, my friend. Why is the text so fucking small? Hey, thought you could leave without saying goodbye?
Hey, Connor.
Johnny.
I had an amazing night yesterday. I didn't know you were so talented and skillful. I also enjoyed staying in the hotel. I already miss you, honey. Next time, I will win in Smash Brothers, so be prepared to get wrecked. Till next time.
Okay. No matter where you two are, whether it's a hallway across the... halfway across the world, hallway? Halfway across the world, or any sky away, you'll always be with me. Jesus Christ. Depressing. Jesus. Fucking sad to think about. Jesus. My aunt's wedding. Garden City's wedding. I'm not invited, lol. Protagonist had a really cool spiked hair. Oh, oh. Are you saying I'm fucking Sasuke? I'm not fucking Sasuke. What the fuck, dude? Sasuke's a little bitch. What? What? Somewhere down the line. Someone down the line could be watching this. I want you to save Joey, Connor, and everyone else. You must complete your mission. Can't take his schizophrenia pills. No. No, dude. What the fuck? When you're about to marry a degenerate that likes ugly bastard. True. I mean, yeah, that's what it would look like. It's going to be a spicy season, boys. Emirichu died as PewDiePie mentioned they're moving to Japan. Connor scouting for guests for the crane game and cosplay videos. Hostage. Jesus Christ. Poor Rainho. Oh my god. Another variety finds its way. Flashbacks episode 82. Evil Gaunt, Connor the Fallen. You and I are not so different. Alright, here we go. Here's a Metal Gear. That's what it felt like, man. Bro, he had nano machines, dude. His body is too strong. I couldn't do anything to Takeshita. He's too powerful.
You're so tiny? No. Dekash just fucking massive. Dekash just built like a brick shithouse, chat. What are you saying? I'm like a normal size height. Dekash just built like just an absolute giga chad. Holy shit. Good music, though. I just love the music. Welcome to the Trash Taste Podcast. I'm here with the girls. Fucking hell. Joey looks fucking cursed. Joey looks so cursed. Once he stopped searching for the boys, he realized that he had found himself and was capable of a possible villain for the Dark Tale. Oh my god. Gaunt Multiverse of Madness. Okay. When all is according to Kikaku. Why am I like this? Why did I do this? I don't remember why I did this. The Giga Chads of Japan. Gigu Chad. Have not seen Full Metal Alchemist. Still his favorite anime. The Giga Man. Is one of the biggest anime tubers. Doesn't watch anime. Sea Dog VA. Is a straight male. Sucks dick anyway. What the fuck? A Chad in Japan. Affable. My god. Oh! Yay! Oh, we've seen this one. You saw this one earlier. This is amazing. Length. Year. Oh yeah, we our episodes went up in length. I want to watch the whole thing so I don't miss a second. I'll have to take several days by watching it. 2 hours. 4 hours. Oh cool, new video. Watched it in one go. Oh, when's the next one coming out? Oh my god. We put out so much! When your friend mentions one word that cracks you up every time. Poop. Jesus. I mean, what can you say? What can you say? Conclusion of the Dark Timeline. Gaunt attains godhood and proceeds to face the evil taste from alternative timelines in an epic climactic battle to save the world. Just can't keep up with this. Not the multiverse. Okay, the Council of Gaunts. Alright, okay, what the what the fuck is this one? Gaunt on his wedding. Gaunt watching Spy. True. Oh my god, oh fucking hell, him saying it again. Monkey giving mouse a haircut. Joey, have you seen the maid cafe? Have you been to a maid cafe? Connor, absolutely not. Also Connor. Well, it's different when I'm filming and when I'm going to like experience it, you know what I mean? It's different. I don't consider it the same. When I go to film and I go there, it's different. It's like, I don't know, it's different. It's not copium, chat. There's no, oh my god, I keep burping. There's no copium, dude. Like, I don't know why you guys keep saying copium. There's zero copium, dude. Your boy, the boy your father wore. Oh my god. Christian.
This question wouldn't come up, but.
Oh, wait, hold on. Christian, the boys discussing Apex Raid of Shadows. Chris sent me this image. He loved this one. Fucking God's face, dude. And Chris looks like a fucking turtle that's like sniffing a big fart. It's so good, dude. It's so good. It's so fucking good, dude. Oh god. Jesus Christ, dude. Ugly bastard Gaunt. Gaunt's like buff in this though. Man props, dude. Actually leaving Trash Taste. Yeah, I spoke about this earlier as well, for those who missed it. Yeah, just explained that, you know, obviously when you have interns on, you know, you only keep interns on for so long. Otherwise, it's not fair to them and it's not fair to you guys as well. Because, you know, you can't, the intern, they can't really, like, do much because they have to come in every now and then. So, we couldn't really give them a full-time job. So, yeah, we weren't able to keep them on. So, yeah, that's what happened. I saw people, like, speculating. It was really annoying. I saw the comments and I was like, it's so annoying when shit like this happens because some people just assume like the worst and it's like, no, there's nothing to it. It's just, you know, just how it is. All right. Next meme. Dadis likes Sundari. Emerichu is one. They finally date. Dadis reveals he's into teacher. Emerichu used to be a teacher in school. I didn't make that connection, but that makes so much sense now. I was just reading my cultured mangas, and
Castle translation. They used fucking God in a Dogen. Holy shit. Holy fuck, dude. Jesus Christ.
The official first episode.
Yeah. 1 second from every trash this episode.
Oh, shit, Doraemon is an anime.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
And playing professional chess was weird to begin.
The bottom half was just like this.
They made a game for me. The beeps and the boops are very pleasing.
I've been a monk in my life.
Hi, I'm the girl here.
Take a ship through their mailbox.
Fuck you, Connor!
What?
But you can bribe them.
Damn it, I wanted you to get horny.
What? Yeah. It was like this deep.
Fuck anime. I hate anime.
One thing, though, that I...
Funny, she's so cute!
And so I start doing like, fuck this.
What is this warm feeling in my pants?
I'm basically an Alzheimer's patient.
Has Connor broken another car?
And SpongeBob's been on like full volume.
I'm a huge fan of Critical.
Yeah, I love seeing the world go.
It's like, bang, 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 bang. Two in one, baby.
I get paid for going on holiday.
Crossless gang, where you at?
Santa likes beer.
I served Prince Andrew and Elon Musk.
It's like a classy pocket pussy. That's...
I want to shit like a king.
We need to come up with like the gacha police.
You better prepare your fucking anus here.
If I could abandon porn, I would.
I walk animation, I shit animation.
Yeah,
young,
yeah.
Dumb, and full of calm.
Fuck you.
Anime is not exactly real.
Who wants to put a condom on this?
I'm kind of fucking with this.
Hee. Oh yeah, I think that's your dick.
Then I made a few people cry.
Stop making British memes.
I've watched Mandarin Peppa Pig.
It's a fucking great game. Play Apex Legends.
Do you have a kimono?
Can you be cancelled for being racist in your sleep? You immediately have to get them drunk.
I just want to kiss my homies goodnight. Trash taste award winner.
Japanese banks suck.
Viscous breakfast spreads.
Why is there incest in this story?
Bye, old studio.
We won, guys.
We won.
To Trash Taste Season 2.
We're like playing Apex Raid of Shadows. I don't think roller coasters are fun at all.
Like, I really want to become a voice actor.
I knew you were a fucking mouth breather.
The Fast and Furious franchise is overrated. Haven't read Hunt Hunter yet.
The absolute state of British rowing.
We had an emu war and we lost.
JoJo fans, when they see it unsucked, boneless or bone?
It's tough.
Oh, so good.
Calls you little baby man.
The go-to Chris Turin at the moment.
When you jack off, do you wear a shirt?
Yes, yeah. I'll just let my beard grow out. I worked at the BBC. Oh, did shit. You know that?
I'm absolutely ripped.
The Family Mart socks.
I did a staring contest one time.
This says a lot about society.
Andy, I just threw eggs at people's houses.
I got the Goku drip jacket.
Army of taxi drivers.
Black Goku. What a way to end the year.
Me, 90% of bread tastes the fucking same.
Have you ever licked sweat?
God, cuddle me now.
What doesn't suck in UK?
I was described as affable.
You guys never licked bathwater before?
I love the banana getcha.
God? Your name's God?
Didn't he murdered my family? I've been in a band before. And
kids out for the boys!
A deer would just fuck me up.
Common sense has definitely become less common.
Exactly. We suck as humans.
I know.
Yeah.
Have you ever coughed and shit at the same time?
No. Am I weird? I like earthquakes.
We're coming for your freezes. Okay? It all comes back to the food, yep. Okay?
To do a marriage interview.
I have the cleanest asshole in America.
Episode 100.
Wow. Amazing. Thank you. That was awesome. Thank you so much, man. That was amazing. Nicely done. Come. Just come. More dark timelines. More dark timelines. Typical JoJo fan meetups. True. I'll probably review a few more and then I'll probably call it for the day. Teacher, what do you want to be in future? Me. Dr. Milf? Sorry, Dr. Ligma Milf Commander? Oh my god. Spy X family joke? Alright, I've seen that one. Thanks for the MILFs. You're amazing. I wish I had this. I wish that was me. Pokimane, ask this question about poop. The boys, allow us to introduce ourselves. Yeah, Pokimane tweeted, why do guys take so long in shitting? I think all of us replied to her about how we love to poop. Anime talk, food takes. Do you guys really like food talks that much? I guess that's good to know. Go on, say the thing. Say the thing, sigh. What's up, you carnivorous coochie cat dog? Oh god, that's so cursed. Oh god. Oh god. No. It's a gacha game. What's the rest of the meme? Joey the anime man used to play gacha. Oh my god. Oh my god, dude.
Japan is clearing up the damage after a powerful earthquake. The 7.4 magnitude quake, which struck late last night off the coast of Fukushima, has killed at least 3 people.
Oh my god.
That's 2 earthquakes.
It was a level 6 just.
Yeah,
hit.
That was a level 6.
Fukushima.
Oh. Well, that's a big earthquake. Oh shit. Oh shit, this is a big one. Oh shit.
I've never seen my street almost in complete darkness. This is freaky as hell.
Guys? Anyone?
Wow. Wow. Whole life is officially part of the MCU. Oh, okay. I guess that makes sense. Where do they go? This is basically what the podcast is like. It's to get you to watch it. I like chickens with the bone. I can't believe you said that. Why? You like boneless chicken, huh? The flavor comes from the bone. I guess they'll like trash taste then. That's what we do. JoJo fans preparing their jaw for another sesh be like, why did I do this? I don't know why I did this. Why did I do this? I wish I remember why I did this. Are you in any way related to Sydney? God, a domestic girlfriend degenerate. No, but it'd be a lot hotter if I... Oh God, awful, awful. What's this? Is it the bad end?
What's your name?
We're getting
the
family map, right?
Are
we?
The final proof we need to confirm that we are on the darkest timeline. The darkest timeline. There is only one path. There is only one path.
We have to go back!
What the fuck? Oh my god, that's terrifying.
Oh no, oh no. Oh no, we're gonna be chased.
Hey guys!
Gantic.
If you follow me or my content, you may know that...
Damn, this is good.
I like to mention
look at edit.
That I worked for the BBC.
I don't know what the fuck happened. I'm not even gonna pretend like I know. Some starving African kid. Reporters. Oh god. Trash Taste timeline. We're making an episode about Trump in Japan. Chris staying outside of Way's opinion. Spoiler. Oh, it's from Takeshita. Can I share it? Yeah, he fought Hangman. I heard the fight was amazing. I haven't watched it. I've heard it was amazing. That's an influential chimpanzee of the sun. That's so good. I love monkeys, dude. I love monkeys. Karate was telling you after COVID. Yeah, I don't even know if she's seen any of it. She probably doesn't even know what this is. Oh, God. Oh, God. Let's get this man on Trash Taste ASAP. Who knows? Maybe one day. I have no idea. Connor and Jerry and Doc's timeline chilling in the East Coast world. I'm maidenless. I'm maiden. Oh, my God. I must know. Haha, Connor. All the female friendships get sexualized. Sage. Oh, this is the fucking big one. Dark rewriting timeline history. Dark gone rewriting reality because it's mid. What did I just say? Who? What's with this sassy lost child? True. God needs to save the universe. Jesus Christ. Trash Taste cartoon animated timeline is the timeline. Iron Mouse is the fourth member of Trash Taste, not Chris Broad. More fan art. I'm not going to watch this clip. It makes me cringe. You guys can watch it. I'm sure you guys have seen it. I don't know what clip it is, but I know she's going to say some crazy, crazy cringe shit. Rain does it on fucking purpose, dude. 6 feet under and bury your mistakes. Wow. Oh, no. I don't know what's going on with the lore, but I fuck with it. Yes, that's right. You're safe now. No, stay with me. Don't leave. And then there's the Golden Requiem. Dude, this fan art looks sick. I can't wait for the rest of this. All right. Okay, I think we've gone through enough memes for today. All right. Okay, I want to give the award today for the good best memes or best contribution. I want to give it to Sir Lugo. Not just for the one piece, but just for all the pieces. I feel like they've contributed so much art that I feel like, you know, there's been some really cool edits, but they've done so much cool art that I want to just give them the award. The approved meme. The Connor's Seal of Approval Award. So let's chuck it on. Let's chuck it in there. Let's give it to them. And boom. You now have the Connor Seal of Approval Award. I guess it's there. I promise, chat. It's there. Congratulations. So Lugo, your memes are on point, my dude. Please keep posting like your amazing art. It's so fucking good. We're spoiled by the art that you send. Please keep it up, man. It's such good. Can't wait for the Iron Mouse thingy one that you did. I'm excited for it. It looks hype. Hype as fuck, dude. All right, boys. But for now, that's me. I guess, I hope you enjoyed this. Oh, let's do the YouTuber outro. Let's do it. Well, I tried my fucking best to understand the Trash Taste lore. Sadly, it's impossible difficulty. I don't know what the fuck is going on. I don't know if it's going to get worse next time, but we'll find out. And you'll find out too if you subscribe to the ConnorDog YouTube channel. It's free, and I mean, why wouldn't you do it? It's no commitment. Just smash the subscribe button. Make sure to do it. Most of you aren't subscribed. You should subscribe for sure. You should do it. And make sure to come watch the streams live at twitch.tv/cdova. And if you haven't already, make sure to follow me there because you'll know when I'm live. I guess that's it. And I'm live 3, 4, 5. And if you want to come catch me live, I'm live. And if you want to come catch me live, I'm live 3 to 4 times a week, normally on Twitch. And you can come catch me there at twitch.tv/cdova. Make sure to follow me. All right, done. YouTuber done.